मैडम स्टार्ट प्लीज। मैडम आपका माइक्रोफोन म्यूट पे है।
हेलो
हाँ
हेलो
यस मैडम, मैडम आप चालू कर सकते हैं, लाइव हो गया है।
बूमा हैज टू स्टार्ट सर,
म्यूट को ऑफ करो। बोलो
हेलो बूमा।
नो इट इज ओके, प्लीज कंटिन्यू।
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द डिग्निटरीज प्रेजेंट हियर टुडे। It's my pleasure to host this event on behalf of the SAA College of Higher Education. This is Bhuma Halpert, the Training and Placement Convener and Assistant Professor. Would like to extend a warm welcome to our guest of honor, Mr. Ramesh Palavnur, sir, President-elect, Rotary Club Thane Navten, our Honorable President, Mr. K.V. Ranganathan, sir, our ever-supportive Management Committee members, and our Principal, Dr. Padmaja Arvind, ma'am, to this first of our career workshop series, Tarkash 2021 Road to Success. Wisdom is not a product of schooling, but of the lifelong attempt to acquire it. As the saying goes, completing a degree does not make one wise, but it is one's attempt lifetime to acquire it makes the difference. In attempting to acquire a degree, it is imperative for the younger generation to upskill themselves to face the realities of the world and build their dream career. With this, let us move on to our next segment of the event. Vedyaya Veda Rupaya Vedantaya Namo Namaha Guna Dosha Vivarjinaya Guna Dilipthaya Namo Namaha. It means, Ma Saraswati, who is Veda herself, the source of all knowledge, whose form represents the Vedas, and whose essence is the culmination of all Vedas, contained in the great Vedanta, salutations to her, whose transcendental essence is free from virtues and vices, yet whose form shines with all virtues, salutations to her. Let us invoke the blessings of Ma Saraswati to give us strength, wisdom, and courage to take us ahead in all our endeavors. Let us do a virtual lamp lighting ceremony. Ishan.
Yes, madam.
You can start with the lamp lighting, sir.
Ishan. Share.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Am I audible? Yeah. Waiting for somebody? Are we waiting for somebody?
Vidya Danam Sarvadana Pradanam. It means only wealth which increases as we spend and share among others. Similarly, it is the knowledge that would increase as we spend and share with others. We, the essayites, believe knowledge is power and hence leave no stone unturned to acquire, attain that power. A dream that was nurtured, a belief that was given shape, and a value that was inculcated, and a desire that became a reality. And that is how the SAI College of Higher Education started its beginning. The college believes in technical excellence combined with latest teaching techniques can result in quality education. We now request our principal madam to address the audience. Over to you, ma'am.
Good morning to one and all who are present here for today's event. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you for the annual career festival Success 2021. Being traditional at heart, SIA College of Arts, Science and Commerce recognize itself as a family, formerly known as SIA Parivar, in the community. It draws its cultural values from its South Indian root, Kudumbam, in Tamil. Every member of the institution, right from its students, teachers, management, and supporting staff, share an emotional bond. For a college that is only a decade old, it has been aspirational and consistently striving towards being a techno-savvy institution, consistently trying to set an example how the new age education system needs to be agile. Creepers and climbers cannot grow without support. The placement cell of the college provides support to the students, creepers, to grow erect by organizing various workshops, training, and industry expert lectures to connect the students with fast, dynamic industry expectations. Wishing you all a grand success. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Every achievement is nurtured by a hope, a belief, and a trust to see beyond times and encourage and motivate us to see our potential. A mentor is not just someone who guides us in our path, but a mentor is someone who allows you to see the hope inside yourself. Always supportive with a passion to bring in cutting edge technologies into our institution and encouraging always us to try new things, our beloved President K.V. Ranganathan sir, who's our source of motivation and strength. We have with us our President today, and we, the SIA Parivar, would like to thank you for all the support that you have been extending to us. And it also happens that today to be his birthday. So on behalf of the SIA Parivar, I take this opportunity to wish sir a very happy and joyful birthday and success in all your endeavors, sir. I now request our president to share his thoughts.
Very good morning. Thank you one and all. Rector Mr. Ramesh Pallavo and other presenters, Dr. Padma Jarwin, the principal of the SIA College of Higher Education, Mr. Boma Alpet, the convener for the placement itself. I know we have a, we are going to a tough time. I think it's always said, tough time never lost. It is the tough people who lost the tough time. I think this time also will get over. Add to the problem, we have the cyclone for last 2 days. I think we have also all of us had technical problems. I think I had problem in getting in. I think the network was down and up and down. I think still we are able to think. Actually, I congratulate all the members, the placement committee, for having come up with such a wonderful program for the next 3 days. A small piece of advice to the participating students. Bill Gates is today in the news for wrong reasons, I think. About 25 years ago, he wrote a book called Business at Speed of Thoughts. So what it means that today, I think agility in all fields is taken as given. I think there is no much time to do execute things. I think everything is required as of yesterday. I think the next generation has to be prepared for that. Another analogy I would try to give you is most of the generation didn't see the telephones. They straight away came into the mobile phone. I think that is what is also expected of the knowledge workers and the students who aspire to be the professionals of tomorrow. Something is taken as given. Something is taken as given. I think right the way you have overlooked the telephone revolution and you have come straight away come into the mobile telephone technology. I think similarly your knowledge is supposed to be multiple times what was expected of you maybe 20 years ago, 30 years ago, 40 years ago. I know the child today of 16 years is more matured, has more knowledge than we as individuals had at the age of 40. There's so much of information explosion. If the information is not converted into knowledge, it's no use. Please convert the information into knowledge, put it to your use. The second thing is you need to have multiple facets of skills for you to survive. Today, if someone says, I know only this, I do not know. If somebody is an engineer, he doesn't understand finance or accounts, he may not be able to do business. Similarly, everybody needs to have additional skill sets if you have to survive in this industry. And what is happening more and more is, I don't know whether you have heard about the gig workers today. Today, I think nobody is wedded to an institution 30 years or 40 years, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years. Today, I think there's a lot of demand for skillful workers who can work for multiple organizations from their home, or maybe work once or twice in a week in a certain organization, earn a lot of money. So the paradigm of education, employment, everything is going a major change. I think the students of tomorrow need to adapt to this if they have to be successful as an entrepreneur or as a professional tomorrow. I think with this in the background, I think we have started this workshop for you students for next 3 days. And we'll be coming up with more and more workshops to so that these students of Dombivli or other colleges or our college are equipped to deal with the industry tomorrow when they go out. We want to give them abundant knowledge so that there, when they go and sit in an environment or when they start their own business, they got enough knowledge to be successful in their endeavor. I don't want to take more time. My best wishes, let this function be, this program be a roaring success. May God bless you. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir, for all the motivation and support and for your kind words. Let's move on to the next part of this session. How did this Tarkash 2021 came into existence? So just a small glimpse about it. Tarkash 2021 is an event which was born during the culmination of our thoughts, where we felt that nothing should stop the learning of our students and helping them attain their aspirations. Understanding the confusions, fear, and thought that goes behind the young minds who is looking forward for some kind of a support system which is going to help them relate and recognize their aspirations, we realize that nothing can replace but the experience of the learning from those who have gone through the same path. Thus, the seed to Tarkash was sowed. A three-day workshop spanning across different topics presented by the practitioners was initiated, and today we are beginning with the first day of the event. So as we move on to the first day of our workshop, we have with us today our guest of honor, Mr. Ramesh Palavpur sir, who is the president-elect of Rotary Club Thane North End. I now request Babita madam to introduce the guest for the day. Babita ma'am.
Yes ma'am. Okay. Good morning everyone. I take this opportunity to introduce today's guest of honor, Mr. P.N. Ramesh sir. Sir was born and brought up in Kolar Goldfields. This place is about 100 kilometers from Bengaluru, Karnataka. He did his schooling from Lindsay Memorial High School and his mechanical engineering from Malan College of Engineering in Hassan. He joined Oil and Natural Gas Commission in 1985 as a trainee driller in the India project in Tripura and then transformed to Bombay High Oil Fields. Sir has worked in many contractor companies like Sedco, Forex, Acer and Aban in various positions in many operator companies like GSPC and AADNOC in various positions. Sir has worked in many oil and gas fields in India, Philippines and in USA. Sir has been actively involved in the drilling and exploration and development of many new oil fields. Sir has been in oil industry close to 35 years. Now sir is retired and does some oil field consultancy work. Mr. Ramesh resides in Thane. On the personal front, sir is married to Bhuma and they have one son living in USA. Currently, sir is president-elect of Rotary Club of Thane North End. So with this brief introduction, I welcome today's guest of honor, Ramesh sir.
This particular event, Tarkash, as we were planning, we had got the opportunity to interact with several industry experts. And then what we realized is, even before we send our students out into the market, there are certain key areas that we need to address. And when we were interacting with some students over a period of time, we had also realized certain things that are going on in their mind for which they really needed a lot of support. So that's how the placement team, along with the management experts who are with us in our team, we discussed and we said that even before we send our students for any placement, we need to empower them not only with the knowledge related to that particular industry, but at the same time, we should also help them and guide through several processes, several other processes. So one such thing is understanding what they want to do and what are their aspirations and what is that is going to support them in attaining the same. So that is how the three-day workshop which we have curated, we have not only focused on the industry-specific subject areas, but we have also considered right from supporting the students in terms of understanding what are their aspirations, what are their career goals, if they have already identified and if they are still confused, how can we help them to understand what are their aspirations. And in addition to that, we are also having some of the topics wherein we are focusing upon what type of skill sets are relevant to the current industry and how do they acquire them. And more so, today it is very important that you need to have a visibility in the market. And we are all going digital. and in the digital platform, creating a footprint becomes
Madam,
very
sir important. Sir, connect ho gaya hai.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, main live dalta hu sir ko.
So yeah. Therefore, keeping this in mind, what we decided was we should also offer a session on how to brand yourselves via the LinkedIn Business Professional Networking Forum. So this will help the students to identify the right kind of mentors, and not only that, it would also help them in their career path. And in addition to that, we are also focusing upon some of the current hot topics and the areas where students can find opportunity, which is covered up in the second and third day. Plus, in addition to our degree students, we also felt it is important, especially for the 12th standard students who are waiting to join a degree program, and with the current pandemic scenario where they don't get to meet each other, and also there are a lot of queries and questions in their mind, we thought we would also open this forum for junior college students as well. So today we have in this session both the degree as well as junior college students. And our guest of honor, Ramesh sir, has already joined in. Over to you, sir.
Oh, thank you so very much, and a very good morning to all of you. I hope I am loud and clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, on the onset, I would like to take and make a small apology, like a typical guest who arrives late. I also on this digital media fumbled on the way and did arrive a little late. For that, my apologies, because I had some problems with the Teams, and your IT guys helped me out with it. So thank you so very much. I would like to thank the principal, Dr. Padmaja Arvind, and the president, Mr. K.V. Ranganathan, for the fantastic introduction they have made and brought me into this session. I would also like to thank Mr. Suresh Ram and Bhuma for introducing me to this concept of what this Tarkash of what you are doing. So without much ado, let me get into this. My dear young students who are there on the threshold of your life, getting your pieces of degrees and stepping out into the, with all the bravery, into this new world. So when Suresh Ram, my colleague in Rotary, suggested that I come and talk with you, I gladly agreed and said, hey, let me talk and I will do it. It'd be a great pleasure to be with these kids and talk with them. Then I got thinking that 35 to 38 years ago, how did I do this? I also was a student at that point of time. How did I get into the, what skill sets did I have to get into the world of engineering and get into the world of work? Then actually I checked for the meaning of Tarkash, which means a box of arrows or a quiver. So which in your context, I think means a bunch of tools which you can use in your the career which you choose. So madam, my word of Tarkash is correct. I'm right in that meaning.
Yes, sir.
So meaning basically it is arsenal. Like if you put one word from Hindi to English, I think the word Tarkash can sort of mean arsenal, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now, children, let me see. With my experience, what I have done, like I've been about 35 years in the oil field. I joined as a young guy, done my mechanical engineering, got a job in ONGC, and I just knew it was oil and gas. The only oil I ever knew was like what comes into the petrol, but I had no idea of what went behind it. So I joined the ONGC, and my learning curve started there. The first thing what I would always like all you children to have, very importantly, very, very importantly, is enthusiasm. never ever lose enthusiasm, because enthusiasm, उत्साह सब चीज में होना चाहिए. आप काम कर रहे हैं, आप एक क्रिकेट मैच देख रहे हैं, आप कुछ और धमाल कर रहे हैं, जो भी कर रहे हैं, पूरा एंथुजियाज्म, पूरा उत्साह से करना है, वो दिल से करना है, जो भी कर रहे हैं दिल से करना है. देन आई रिमेंबर, यस, आई वॉज वेरी एंथुजियास्टिक, सो आई वेंट टू, आई वॉज पोस्टेड इन अ प्लेस कॉल्ड त्रिपुरा इन अगरतला नॉर्थ ईस्ट, एंड इन दोज डेज व्हेन आई लैंडेड देयर, इट वॉज, बिलीव इट और नॉट, जंगल. And jungle part was no issues, but the problem there was, it was an area filled with terrorists. It had a lot of terrorists in those days. Northeast was burning. So when I landed up on my job, it was a hotbed of terrorists there. Then I got worried, hey, how do you going to manage? But there were a bunch of us who with enthusiasm said, no, we will stay here and we will do it. In the job, always remember, children, one more thing. Do not hesitate to do anything that will take you to a goal. I graduated as a mechanical engineer. I had done drawings. I had done high level math. I had done my calculations, heat transfer, thermodynamics, you name it, I could answer. Operation research and the original, like starting Fortran programming, all that we had learned. But when I went into the field, I had to work with my bare hands. I had to work in the dirt. I had to work in the open air. हम बाहर खुले आम करना पड़ा. और ऐसे अभी अभी कभी कभी वो जो काम पे हम चीज को हम अपने खंधे पे उठा के लेके जाते थे, क्योंकि ONGC में वो फील्ड का काम था, और फील्ड का काम में ऐसा नहीं कि ये मेरा काम नहीं, यही बोल नहीं सकते थे हम, और कभी भी नहीं किया हम लोगों ने. सो द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज वर्क विद योर हैंड्स, डोंट हेजिटेट एंड डू कीप द फुल एंथुजियाज्म इन इट. तीसरी चीज मैं जो किया था और आज भी मैं कर रहा हूं, एंड दैट इज डू नॉट स्टॉप लर्निंग. टुडे इवन इन दिस 2 मिनट्स विच आई टुक टू एंटर दिस टीम्स, it has been a learning session for at 6 minutes, where your IT guy, you know, he took me through it and showed me things, and now I have learned one step as to how to go into these things, how to do it. Never ever stop learning, because the moment you stop learning, you will stop progressing. In the oil field, what we always did because of this learning, we would switch jobs very quickly from this job to that job. And when it came to the interview, we would always tell a little more than what we had done, because we were confident that when we get into the new job, we were capable of picking up the new job. We will look at others, what they're doing. We'll ask what others are doing. We will see what others are doing. We will stay back extra and see how he's doing it, and then quickly pick it up, and then tell it that, learn, and then tell, hey, we know this. So a lot of these time jobs, when your enthu for learning is there, you will move a little more faster, because in that way you will be confident that even if you overshoot your biodata or overshoot, you should be capable of picking it up without hesitation. In my field, many of my teachers taught a lot of life-saving, confidence-building knowledge. I did not learn them from my class, but I learned them from simple workmen colleagues. And all, honestly speaking, I was an engineer, and the colleagues I worked with were basically on the, say, diploma holders or even lesser, who had come from ITI schools and all that. All I did was to keep my ego as an engineer out and work at their level and work with them. They would teach me so many things that an engineering college or a higher education will not teach you, especially when you're working in the field, working with your hands, working in a tough situation. They would always go out of their way and help me with things where I would get stuck, because I was had no ego, I would bend down and I would ask them when I got into trouble, and they would so gladly teach me. This I learned, you know, in my school. My school motto was, you have to stoop to conquer. To go get big in life, you don't stand big. You stoop down, leave out your ego, leave out your attitude, and then you go. In Hindi, if you translate it, jeetne ke liye jhukna hai. Aajkal, the world has changed in so many ways. The thinking of the world has changed. The technology has turned upside down. And added, we have this new pandemic, which has come once in 100 years. And it has changed the way we do things. Today, we have to think in innovative ways. This meeting would have been face to face. I would have been sitting there, or met with you. I'll be talking to you in front to face. There will be eye contact. There will be exchange of expressions. I will know when you're interested, when you're bored, when I should start, when I should stop. Now I have to learn to speak to a screen which is so very unresponsive. I cannot see any of your feelings, nor I don't know whether you are getting what I'm trying to tell. So these things I have to learn afresh. These things, you are now at the other end of the screen. So this gives you an added advantage that when you come to this side of the screen, you will be able to do a better than a lot of other things. Always remember, young people, the college from which you come out will give you a degree because you have worked hard, you have put in the hours required, you have passed exams and you have achieved a degree. But do not rest on it, because in the real world outside, so many dangers and obstacles are there. One of the arrows you have in your quiver is the learning that your teachers and your institution and your friends, your libraries, your experimentation, your books, your exams have given you. The knowledge they have accorded you, and put a few of those arrows in your quiver. But when you go out, you must remember that where you stay in your protected environment of your school or college is like a swimming pool. And in real life, when you get into a job, it is an ocean there. In that ocean, there will be sharks, there will be alligators, there will be small fish, big fish, there will be strong currents. And yes, you may float, but whether you will swim or sink depends on how fast you can learn and how quick you can pick up what is going on around you. Do not, my young cousin, when I was in school, you know, taught me how to deal with the obstacles in life. And she told me this little proverb when I was, say, about 7th standard or something. Jeena hai to marna seekho. Khadam kadam se ladna seekho. You have to learn to fight step by step. Every battle is going to be your battle. Nobody else will come and fight your battles for you. You have to learn. You have to swallow your egos. You have to swallow your attitudes. You have to pick up the knowledge, pick up the skill, and then go ahead. You know, this coming to this knowledge and attitude and enthusiasm when it comes in. In quite my career, we suddenly came that computerization was introduced. There was computerization. Suddenly, everybody started with computers. Like all the banks started having computers, railways, and the oil field was not far behind. We too got a bunch of computers. And then now, who will work the computers? Very few people knew how to operate the computer. They used to be one or two guys whom, if you had to get some job done out of it, and they said compulsorily some jobs have to be done out of it, you had to go begging that person who knew the job. So then I and my wife, we went and joined this computer course in Apple. We did a 15-day course in all basic Microsoft Office suite, which was then the thing that was useful for me. Myself and my wife, we were the oldest student in our class. You know, the rest of us, rest of them were say half or half or less than half my age. But then, because I had that enthusiasm for learning, that keenness to acquire that new knowledge, and I was willing to sit in a class with young kids and learn to a teacher who was half my age, I was able to quickly acquire that skill and use it. Computers then later became an in thing in the oil field. If you don't know how to work in a computer, you are sort of like the dinosaur in the oil field. Many of those dinosaurs perished and went. So you also need to keep updating your skills. The skills which come, I'm just giving an example of computer. It can be anything. The skills, if you are going into, say, fixing up an infrastructure and you are learning doing electrical work, you need, there are so many new things coming. If you are doing, and say you're getting into the plumbing and water supply, there are so many new things are coming. It is not like the old days that there was one pipe which will come from your municipality and you use it in all over your house. Now it's not like that. Now you have water treatment, you have wastewater recovery, you have water treatment plants, you have systems where you conserve water, and you have electrical and mechanical sensors which will switch on and switch off the water and make sure you consume so many less.
+912249360928.
Okay, so remember to upgrade your knowledge. Another thing which I always, which personally, which I feel we all have to do is, in life, you should play fair and square. The game you play in life should be honest. Like any game you play on a serious note, there are some places where you'll be a big, big success. Other places you will make mistakes. And when you are on a job getting into it, you will make mistakes. Believe it or not, you will make mistakes. You'll make plenty of it, and you'll make seriously bad mistakes. In my career, I always found out that when I made a mistake, I went and I owned up to my mistake. Honestly speaking, I went and said, sir, this is what I've done. This is the mess I made. This is the mistake. Here, mere haath se itna bada ek galti ho gaya. Main maan raha hoon. And then at that point of time, yes, I did get yelled at. I did get shouted at. I did get some written warnings about. I did get everything done. But then once the mistake was fixed, they would take back everything they said against me and they would say, okay, no problem. Now you have done it, but next time don't repeat it. Down in my career, as I grew up in the ladder of the industry, I did ask a manager that, sir, when I made a mistake, you yelled and screamed at me, but then you forgive me for my mistake. He said, Ramesh, remember when you made a mistake, you came and clearly told us what had happened. So once we knew what had happened, 50% of our jobs was done, that we did not have to investigate what was done. You told us what has happened. So all we needed was to find the solution, which obviously would definitely cost money and time and would ruffle a few feathers on the top management. But at the end of the day, we could find a solution and we could clear the problem. So you, by owning up your responsibility, used to solve our problem by 50%. And that is a very big thing. Honesty counts. Honesty is very important in any industry. Once you are known to be an honest person who is an upfront person, there will be people who will trust you. When I used to work in the UAE, I had a lot of nationalities with whom I used to work with. And there was one person, I'm not going to name the nationalities, making it biased. He used to be very dodgy in the way he reports. And I used to work back to back with him. Like, he will work some 12 hours, I will work the next 12 hours. So my boss and all of them, once he finishes, they will come to me and ask me, hey, how he has done it. Has he reported correct or has he reported wrong? When they would, among two colleagues, they would very quietly come and trust me because they knew that I will honestly tell them what has been there and what is not there. What I have done is what I have done, what I have not done, what I have not done. Mistake is a mistake. I can't help. I did not do it on purpose. It happened. I am human. So that's the way I used to explain my mistakes and we used to go ahead. The last thing I want, from all of you, very importantly, this is what as Indians we lack. I put this to everybody, even to all my colleagues. We have to be professional and importantly, we have to be proud of what we do. If you are not proud of what we do, you should not be in there. You should find something else where you will be proud. You take, for example, the soldier. He is so proud being the soldier because he has a certain standard. He has a certain way of ethos. How did that come up? Because all of them as soldiers, they got together and said that this is the way we'll work. This is the way we'll do our things. Same way, all of you in your jobs should be proud and of your work and show this pride around. Your pride, if you are proud of your job and you have pride in your skills, you will not do anything that is below par, below standard, or below the qualities that is accepted. Today, you go around India, go around your own place, wherever each of you are. All I'm requesting all the teachers and students, everybody go around, check all the how the telephone lines are laid out, check how the signal system is laid out, check how the building are laid out, check how our roads are made. Do you think anybody who had pride in his job will do a shoddy job like that? Will you as a student be a poor student? Will a teacher be a poor teacher? Will me as an engineer be a poor engineer? Me as a manager be a poor manager? Because I'm proud in my job, I want to make sure that when a job is done, it has my trademark in it. My branding is that this is Ramesh has done this job. So they will say, hey, this is Ramesh's job. We don't have to look at it. It will be one of the best quality jobs. Each of you need to get that inside you that, hey, I am proud of my job. I take pride in my work and what I do will be the best quality that I can offer. We lack on this pride of our profession. This pride was there when before in those days that it used to be inculcated that you have to have pride of your work. Be proud of your workmanship. Yes, that's the word I was looking for. Workmanship, that skills. Today we are sadly, whether I'm being truthful or not, we are lacking those skills. Truthfully, we are lacking those skills. And we are definitely tolerating the bad work and we have reduced our pride of being today being proud of an Indian itself because of all this shoddiness around being calling ourselves pride or being an Indian itself is so difficult in these modern times. But if you go to say a temple, a 1,000-year-old, say if you go to Meenakshi temple, you will be so proud to be an Indian because you can see the skill there. You go to Ajanta or Ellora and you stay there. You are proud because you see the skill set that has gone into that work. You like to be associated with that. So are you doing that today in your job, in your own little way? So please ensure that pride is there in your job. And last important thing is, again, I had said, the honesty. I can't stress enough of being honest. Be honest. Be truthful with yourself. Be truthful to your profession. Do not allow anybody to take shortcuts. Do not allow anybody to cut corners. You if you are known as an honest person, you will grow slower, but you will grow bigger. You will be expensive. Your services will be expensive, but people will pay for expensive service because they know at the end of the job, they are getting honest work. Today, for example, if you take a simple example, if you take one of the companies, say you take a Tata's. So today, Tata's is associated with honesty. He is not associated with bigness or size or holding size. No, his important is honesty. Today, when a Tata sells a product, you don't question whether there is any shortcuts or anything he has taken in it. You know everything. What he says is what he has done. What you see is what you get. You are not shortchanged in anything. That is the type of reputation each and every one of you needs to build. In my professional career, I did build it. It took a while to build a reputation like this. It takes a lot of hard work. It takes a lot of perseverance to work and do this big job. But if you keep at it, there is no profession or skill set that is smaller and bigger. Every skill set has the same level of importance in society. There can never be a sense that one, because it just pays a little more, is more important than one that is lesser paying and less important. No, every skill set is important. And that is one more thing each of us also need to learn, that we have to respect the other profession. Be aware of the skills and the hard work that goes into it and be respectful of it. Just because one of us sits in an AC office and another guy stays in the open air and works, the person sitting in the AC office should never assume that the person working outside is something lower or below, or he's not doing something that's up to the mark. No, both of you are equally important for a society. As much as you are there in an AC room with a clean shirt and that person working outside with dust on him, both of you, as far as the work skills goes, are same, and there is no, absolutely no difference between both of you. Respecting the working person is a very important point which all of us should remember. We should remember that the person who does the job, and if we give him that respect and treat him as a person in society, his product which he gives to us will be much, much superior than what he would ordinarily have done. I think I've taken up a lot of your time, and with this, I want to wish you all the very best in your careers and your life. Please take care, and good day to you all. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir. We got to learn a lot of life lessons from your experience and your past experience around the globe and different companies have really, you know, that speaks a lot from whatever you have said. And I'm sure we have a lot of takeaways from this talk of yours, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
As we are moving to the end of today's inaugural, and we would be starting with the session soon, I would also want to tell everyone that it's also a day of coincidence that our President Ranganathan sir and also our guest of honor for today, Ramesh sir, both of them share their birthdays together as well. So as great leaders and mentors, so both of them are in this. So just a small thing from our SAA Parivar, sir, for both of you. Happy birthday to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so very much.
Happy birthday to you, sir. Ranganathan, sir. Thank you so much. So, dear participants and attendees, we'll be quickly starting with the first session for today. That would be a goal setting session called Laksh. And we'll be handing over the session shortly to our guest Jyoti Gujran ma'am. And before that, I would request Ishan to take over the further part of the session. And I request all the attendees to please rename yourselves with the name in which you have registered. And second important thing is, like, also please try to keep yourselves on the mute mode so that there won't be any disturbance to the proceedings of the session. And thirdly, like, once this particular session is completed, we'll also be sharing a link for the second session. That would be post 1 o'clock session that we are having. So you'll have a separate link for the same. So please join the second session through that particular link. But as of now, the session one and session two for today will be through the same link. We'll be continuing. And the last session for the day would be through the separate link. Over to you, Ishan.
Thank you, Bhuma ma'am. Is my voice clear and audible?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Namaste, Adab, and a pleasant morning to one and all. This is your host, Ishan Iyer, from Department of Management Studies and Economics. Welcomes you all for Tarkash, A Road to Success. Do not wait, the time will never be just right. Start where you stand and work with whatever tools you may have at your command. And better tools will be found as you go along. That's the agenda SIA has taken today, irrespective of bad weather gifted by Cyclone Tauktae. Dosto, jo safar ki shuruaat karte hai, wo manzil ko paar karte hai. जो सफर की शुरुआत करते हैं वो मंजिल को पार करते हैं बस एक बार चलने का हौसला रखिए अच्छे इंसान का तो रास्ता भी इंतजार करता है लक्ष्य मेरी राह है मेरी मंजिल द फर्स्ट सेशन ऑफ द डे सो लेट्स वेंचर आउट विद आवर फर्स्ट गेस्ट स्पीकर ऑफ द डे ज्योति गुजरन मैम मैम इज ग्रेजुएट इन कॉमर्स फ्रॉम सिडनम कॉलेज मास्टर्स इन काउंसलिंग साइकोलॉजी फ्रॉम अन्नामलई यूनिवर्सिटी चेन्नई EMBA in Human Resource from IIM Calcutta. Also worked as a counselor and has in employee counseling, children counseling and family counseling. She has been HR professional for last 15 years. She is passionately and dedicatedly associated with Salaam Balak Trust, an author by passion and a trained life coach. We are glad to have you, ma'am, here today. Over to you, ma'am. Thank you.
Ishan, please switch on your camera. Everyone would want to see you as well.
Ma'am, actually, network issue is there from my end. There okay. is no power.
Okay.
Yeah, ma'am.
A very warm good morning to all of you. Before I start, like we heard from everyone, I am facing some technical issues. So can all of you all hear me?
Yes, ma'am. We can.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm pretty audible.
Yes, ma'am. Very much audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you. First of all, a very warm good morning to all of you. It was great hearing the principal and Mr. Ranganathan and all of you all. Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
You are audible. We can hear you, madam.
The reason is because I'm working not on my Wi-Fi. That's the reason why I'm asking these questions. So, it was great hearing all of them speak because all of them spoke a lot about their own experience in life and as to how they feel how important it is to go forward in education, how important the skills are and all that. So we heard quite a bit about all that. Before we start off on Lakshya, so then how do we go about from here? So shall we, since the name Lakshya was a name chosen by all of you, this is a workshop which has been chosen by you, facilitated by you, and organized by you. So friends, sit back and relax and let's see the movie of Lakshya. This is what we wanted for the day, right? Can we do that?
Yes.
Bring out the popcorn, bring out the ice cream, and let's get going, friends. What happened? I can't see any movie being shown. Bhuma ma'am, is there any movie being happening?
Yes, ma'am. He's
Ma'am, just a minute. Sharing.
I think there's no movie of Hrithik Roshan and Preeti Zinta happening. We'll have to change to something else. What do you all say, friends? Agreed? I like the name of Tarkash. Mm. By the way, I also Googled it. I didn't know the meaning. I was very impressed with the name of Tarkash. So I was very impressed with the name and I Googled what it means. And it means like what our president also said, it means a box of arrows. तो अगर लक्ष्य प्रीति जिंटा और ऋतिक रोशन का नहीं होता है तो हम लोग हमारी तरकश से और एक एरो निकाले, लक्ष्य दूसरी लक्ष्य का एरो निकाले. What do you all say, friends? Shall we?
Yes.
Can we have a few answers, please? I mean, why is it that everyone is so quiet?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Only two or three voices. Is it Ishan only who's speaking?
Ma'am, many are there.
Many, I know many are there, but the voices I hear is very minimal. That's what, anyways.
Cannot unmute themselves and talk. Only participants can talk. That is why the number of voices are less.
The number of voices are less? Okay, fine. I'll go ahead with that, this one. So it was great having all of you all here at SI College and hearing all of you all, the way you all went about life, the president, the guest honor, and the principal, and hearing Bhuma and the kind of work that she's doing and all that. So let us take our next arrow from our Tarkash and start. Let us go ahead talking about Lakshya and how important it is for all of us to have a Lakshya. Bhuma ma'am, can you help me out here, please?
Yes, ma'am. Ishan, move on to the next slide.
The first slide has not come on.
Ishan, download it and then open.
Ma'am, is it visible?
Yes, yes. Move to the next slide.
Yeah.
The first slide came on. No, I can't see anything.
Ma'am, might be due to that network.
Ma'am, it's there. It's there.
It's there, ma'am. We can actually see.
Then why am I not able to see?
Probably your end network, ma'am.
Ma'am, yeah, network issue may be there, ma'am.
The second slide is goal setting slide, ma'am, which has opened up.
Is there anything we can do about this if I'm not able, because I'm working on those hotspots since my Wi-Fi is not there. Is there anything we can do, Ishan, about it?
Ma'am, can you rejoin?
Sorry?
Bhuma, ma'am, if ma'am can rejoin, maybe issue can be solved.
Video, switch off your video and see if your screen is visible to you.
Okay,
switching on your video will consume more bandwidth because
I switched off my video.
Now check if you're able to see the screen.
No, I can only see connecting Ishan here on the screen.
Ma'am, can you log out and rejoin again?
You mean leave and come back again?
Yes, yes. Leave and come back again.
I'll do that. Give me a minute, please. Can we go back to the first slide?
Ma'am, now is it visible?
Yeah, yeah, it's visible. It's visible. Thank you, Ishan. Thank you. I suppose it's Ishan only, no?
Yeah, yeah, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you very much, Ishan, for all your support.
Thank you, ma'am.
What we were discussing is, since the movie has not come along, let's discuss something else. So we go ahead and talk about Lakshya, Meri Rahe, Meri Manzil. What does this mean? Can we move ahead? Can we go to the next slide?
Yes, ma'am. Ishan, move to the next slide, please.
Is Ishan the one in the sink? Lakshya, in other words, is mainly goal setting. What is goal setting and why are we talking about goal setting? Goal setting is that facet of your life where you think of something that you want to identify with. So is that so difficult? Probably. You can think about it. Can we go to the next slide? Why should I set goals? Why is anyone? I mean, we have all spoken. I mean, before my earlier seniors have spoken a lot about that we should set goals. Why should I set goals? I should set goals not to achieve them, but to identify what I want to become. Is there a difference? I can see all the question marks and all the faces. Though my camera is off, I can imagine some few question marks. Everyone till now, we always had this meaning in our lives, ki I want to achieve my goal. So what am I talking about when I say that I want to identify with what I want to become? The reason why I say achieve is different from identify is because when I say achieve, it means you're getting something, you're acquiring something for yourself. Your personality is a sum total of so many things in life. Whereas when you set a goal for yourself, it is what you want to become in life. You think that you want to become a painter, you want to become a sculptor, you want to become a chartered accountant, you want to become an engineer. You can be anything. That is something that you want to become in life as you grow further, as you keep growing bigger, older and bigger. This is what you want to become in life. Whereas achieve is a facet of your personality. Things that I want for my personality. I keep getting all those things for my personality. That is why there is a difference between achieving and identifying. This is a psychologist. We are very particular that we say achieving is something that I want to add to my personality. These are things that I want to add to my personality. A personality for any person is made up of so many different facets. If I'm going too fast, please stop me. Bhuma ma'am or somebody can please stop me.
Sure, ma'am. Sure.
Okay. So, but on the other hand, whereas identify with a goal is something that you want to identify yourself with. Like when you spoke about Bhuma ma'am, you all said that she was the training placement coordinator and the convener. And we had the principal ma'am. She had become the principal of SIA College. Similarly, Mr. Ranganathan is a director. So they have reached a particular level whereas they are identifying themselves with that position they have reached. In addition to that position where they have reached, there are so many other things they have got for themselves which go for their personality. That is why it is very, very crucial that we say that we identify with a goal rather than getting a goal. Are you okay till here? Can we move on?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
To identify with that goal, what do I need? That so-called goal, to identify with that goal, what do I need? Skill or will? Now I need some answers, please. Because I don't know the answers for this. There are no right or wrong answers, by the way, friends. You all just say what you all think is necessary to identify with that goal. Come on, friends. Let's have some answers.
Both.
Sorry?
Both.
Both? Okay, that is playing it a little safe, don't you think so? Okay, anyone else? Okay, let me say, what is primarily important? Is it skill or is it will?
Will.
Will?
Primarily, like will is more important.
What? Sorry, I didn't get that.
We can develop our skills also.
If you have the will, you can develop your skill.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, anyone else? Since I don't know the answers, I'm asking you all to answer. So that when I present somewhere else as a speaker, I can write down the answer. That's why I'm asking SIA students, since they're so intelligent, to help me out. Can you all? I can see 213 children. Wow, this is very
good. They are all attendees. They won't be able to unmute and speak.
Okay.
The participants would be able to respond. Whoever is answering, they have the rights to speak. Others can only chat through the Q&A.
Okay, fine. Okay, Bhuma. Yeah. So are the students writing in the chat?
Yes, ma'am. They will write now.
They will write. Okay. So shall we move ahead then?
Yes, ma'am. There are some responses. Both skill and will are required.
Okay.
And again, another response is also the same, both skill and will.
Mm-hmm.
And a few others are saying that it is skill.
Mm-hmm.
Will. Some people are saying it is will, some people are saying it is skill.
So we seem to have a mixed lot of answers. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let me tell you all something, friends. I do understand that there has been a lot of talk earlier on skills and all that. But you can add a lot of skills to your kitty. You can add so many skills that, you know, Mr. So-and-so is an engineer. He's upgraded his skills with further skills of digital marketing. And he's gone on to become also a Clubhouse and all that. He knows all the latest facets that are there. But does he have the will? Does he have the will to use that skill? Our chief guest rightly said that if you have the knowledge, it's not enough. You have to act on that knowledge. What is the use of me having all that knowledge if I'm not going to act on that? To act on that, I need a will. I need that will to push me first, and then I will utilize my skills. So skills is important, but over and above that is will. The reason for adding skill and will is for a slight little bit of confusion to get the right answers from children. So shall we go ahead? We don't have to be so serious on the first day. You'll have 3 days, friends. Let's go ahead. So what are the skills that I need to add to my education? Who are the people I need to surround myself with? To reach any goal, to identify with your goal, you need to have, once you know that your skill is in place, once you know that your will is in place, you have to make a list of the skills that you have. For your particular goal, to identify with that goal, what are the skills that you need? And more about that, who are the people you are associating with? Show me 5 of your best friends and I will tell you the kind of person you are. This is often said. By the way, it's very correct also. You'll go and see the people. I mean, okay, let's take Bollywood. Everyone knows about Bollywood. Take the top stars. Who are the people whom they associate with? Do they associate themselves with people just joining the industry, or do they associate themselves with the top brass itself? Because when you associate themselves with the top brass, they are the people whom they feel very, very comfortable with. They are the people whom they get more and more inputs from. So associating with the right kind of people will make a lot of difference for me to identify with that goal. After I associate myself, then I will have the skills also following. It goes together. First will come associating with people, the will, and then will come the skills. Can we go ahead? Once we have made all this decision of skill and associating with people, there are 4 main decisions in life that we had to take. Car, driver, fuel and direction. Oh my god, I can see the questions. अभी ये कहां से आ गया यार, कार ड्राइवर फ्यूल डायरेक्शन. हमें लगा लक्ष्य है, ऋतिक रोशन प्रीति जिंटा का मूवी है, चलो वो भी नहीं. गोल सेटिंग का पीपीटी है, चलो वो भी नहीं. और ये क्या है, कार ड्राइवर फ्यूल डायरेक्शन. Shall we think for a minute? Shall we go ahead and see how can it be a major decision making factor in our goals? Can we go?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
What does a car give you in life? A car gives you major happiness. A car gives you a lot of happiness, depending on what type of car you want. First thing for yourself, is it that you want a Maruti? Do you want a BMW? Or do you want a Mercedes? What is the type of car you want? So what is car related to? Car is related to your goal, friends. The goal gives you a lot of happiness in life. Similarly, the car also gives you a lot of happiness in life. It makes you mobile, so it gives you a lot of happiness. But for that happiness to be there within you, you need to first identify what is your goal and where are you going to go to. Who are the people who can help you in this? You all have very, very educated seniors in your organization. You all have a very, very well-placed placement consultant, placement convener for y'all, who will put forth an array of choices for you. Your Mooma ma'am can help you with all those. From those array of choices that you have, please choose the right car for you, which is right for you, for your potential and for your aptitude. Only then you cannot sit at home and say that, you know, no, I want a Mercedes. Do you have the ability to buy that Mercedes? Do you have the capacity to buy that Mercedes? These are hardcore decisions anyone has to take. Yes, your goal gives you a lot of happiness, but there are some hardcore decisions any person also has to make. Can we, friends? Good. Once we reach the car, the next is driver. Who's a driver? You, my friends. You are the driver. You are the most important person. You are in the center. You are the pivot of everything going around right moment. Do you have the skill? Do you have the will? Do you have the tools? Do you have all these in the right combination? 33, 33, 33, 100%, 33.3, kitna percent hota hai aisa? Or thoda upar niche, thoda skill upar, thoda will niche, thoda tools upar. But do you have all this in you? If you have all this in you, your way, your car is in the right hands. Your car is in the right hands. Your BMW, your Maruti, your Mercedes is in the perfect person hand. You become the perfect person. The car is chosen. The driver is chosen. Who's next? Can we? A picture is worth a thousand words, they say. Why do they say that? If you'll see in this picture, they're all mostly bags, but I presume they're all very beautiful girls, like we have in your college. You'll have all beautiful girls. Some are tall, some are short, some have short hair, some have long hair. Similarly, the boys in the college, some are tall, some are short, and all are ready to graduate, like y'all will be soon. 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, but y'all are soon heading towards graduation. Once you'll head towards graduation, why is this picture so important? This picture is important because this tells us each person is different. Some will have skill more, some will have will more, some will have tools more, but mandatory, compulsory, they have to have everything in the proportion. Friends, believe me something, they always say a visual impact is always higher than an audio impact. I am going on talking, but you all will remember this picture for a very long time, because the visual impact is always more. That is why we remember movies so much more. Arey, wo picture mein ye dekha tha, wo picture ye dekha tha, right? Do you all say that? I say that. But dialogue hamesha yaad nahi rehta hai. I'm a movie buff, but not so much. So I can remember I can remember a scene, but probably not the audio. Similarly, this picture will always remain because it tells us each person is different. We all come with our own unique skills and own unique wills. And this is how we go ahead. Can we? Next is fuel. What is fuel? Fuel is your revenue, your growth. What is fuel? When I say your revenue, your growth, kahan se aa gaya ye fuel? Revenue, growth. Fuel, my friends, is strategy. Strategy is answer that one simple question of why. Why do you want to become a painter? Why do you think that you are a good sculptor? Why do you think you are the world's best chef? India's best chef, the world's best chef. I do not stop at India. Why should Indians be? Think of you are the world's best chef. Why are you stopping yourself? So why do you think you are the world's best chef? Answer that question, why? That is very, very crucial. That strategy will take you places. You answer that question. The driver has to answer the question. And that answer to that question of fuel is why. Correct? Only you can answer that question. Okay, let me take myself for example. I'm a psychologist. I have completed my psychology and I've put in a decade or more experience in HR. All throughout my experience when I was working in the corporate sector, I used to write, which was also published. I had this innate passion of writing and publishing, but it was more a hobby. I never thought of making it a hobby, a passion which I had. After the lockdown happened last year, I did some hardcore thinking for myself. Going to offices was difficult. And I wanted to have a career which would be fulfilling for me. When I say fulfilling, it should give me growth, it should give me revenue. So I chose to become a full-fledged author. Why? I'm answering the question you all want to ask. Why? What is my strategy? Why did I choose that question? Why did I choose to become an author? I chose to become an author because, simply put, I can write, I can think. What does an author need? He needs those two skills. He needs that will. And I had that will. I knew that I could write. I wanted to go ahead. That was my strategy. I knew what I wanted to become in life. Does it give me revenue? Yes. Does it give me growth? Yes. So being a life coach and being answering, I also become an author. That is my strategy in life. Similarly, friends, you all have to decide. You, the driver, has to decide what is that why for you. Why do you want to become that person? Jo goal likha hai wahan pe, kyun banna chahte ho wo goal? Kyun jana chahte ho wo road pe? Wo pehle sochna padega. My Hindi is little Bombaiya Hindi. So I'm sorry if there are very experts Hindi speaking people in this crowd. So please bear with me. Can we go ahead? Why? Why are they all racing? Why do you think they're all racing ahead? They are all racing ahead to meet their goal. This is the strategy. This is another picture which will remain in your minds. Going on a cycle, wearing a helmet and cycling in full force. You all, my friends, will be in this position 3 years from now, 4 years from now, and ready to meet, identify with your goals, racing towards your goals. You'll have already decided your goal. You'll have acquired the skills that you'll have to have, and you'll are ready to move ahead. Can we? Now you have done, you have finished with car, you have finished with the driver, you have finished with the car, you'll know what car you'll want, you'll know what is your goal. You'll finish with the driver, the most important person, you. And you'll also finish with fuel. What? Why? Why do I want to become that goal? Why do I want to reach that goal? Then, my friends, is direction. Where do I go? Gaadi mein aise hi to nahi baitha jata hai na? Kidhar na kidhar to chalana padta hai, bhai. Do I go to Dombivli? Do I go to VT? Do I go to Churchgate? Do I go to Borivali? Unless I have these answers in my hand, where will my car go? How will my car move ahead? It cannot be stationary. Can the car be stationary? No, friends, it cannot be stationary. It has to be moving with the right will, with the right skill. वो सब होगा तो गाड़ी आगे बढ़ेगी, लेकिन गाड़ी बढ़ना चाहिए एंड राइट डायरेक्शन में. यू शुड नो वेर यू आर गोइंग. वेर आर यू गोइंग? डोंबिवली, वीटी, चर्च गेट, बोरिवली. वेर आर यू गोइंग? नो दैट फॉर योर सेल्फ. ओके, शैल वी? द डिसीजन इज योर्स. व्हाट विल बी योर प्राइमरी फोकस? कार, फ्यूल, ड्राइवर, डायरेक्शन. I'm going on saying these four words again and again, so that the more we keep repeating it, the more we understand how important it is for us to know it. So car, fuel, driver, car, driver, fuel, direction, primary focus in life for the next 3 years, 4 years. Correct? These are the four main decisions you have to make. Next. And then we come to goal versus time theory. What is goal versus time theory, friends? There it shows current and tomorrow. In my current goal, in my current phase of scenario, I have written my goal as first. Second is my friends. Third is fun and entertainment. Fourth is health. And then is love, girlfriend, boyfriend. I do not know. That is my current life. Everyone has told me, Bhuma madam has told me I have to have a goal. My parents have told me I have to have a goal. So, okay, I'm writing goal. I have to have that goal. Uske baad aate mere friends. Then comes fun and entertainment, health, and of course, love in life. So what do you, how much time do you spend? Why is this called goal versus time theory? It is called as goal versus time theory because we need to know how much time we spend on goal, how much time we spend on friends, how much time we spend on entertainment, how much on health, and how much on or other of either or other activities. Do we spend in a day or in a week? Forget in a day. Chalo, ek day to bahut ye hota hai, chota ho jata hai. In a week's time, socho. In a week's time, do I spend 5 minutes on my goal? Do I spend 3 hours with my friends? Do I spend another 3 hours on Netflix and television? Health, I know y'all are not so much because y'all have your parents who take care of your health. And do I also spend another so much hour on all the other activities? Which activities do y'all spend the maximum time today? Make a list of that. Make a list of your current activities. I made a list based on what I have in knowledge. Y'all make a list of based on your current. Education, I have not written because it is mandatory. Or do your education and make your submissions on time. Usme to likhna to hota nahi hai, choice nahi hai, karna to padta hi hai. Correct? So make a list of how much you think you spend time on today. What is the paradigm shift I need to make for tomorrow? For tomorrow, I have to have a different paradigm, friends. If I'm going to identify with that goal, if my gaadi is going to go in that direction, if I have put the fuel, agar skills le liya, motivation bhi hai, sab kuch hai, to a paradigm shift bhi hona chahiye in terms of time. Goal versus time. Goal aise hi nahi banega. See the time that you have spent. Change the timings. Kiske liye kitna time spend karte ho aap log? And make that time shift depending on what you want in life. Do you want it continuing like this? 5 minutes on your goal, 2 hours on fun and entertainment, another 2 hours on Netflix, and probably your friends. Friends are very, very important. I do understand that for your age, friends are very important. It's important at every age. Is it where? But how much time do I spend on that? How much time do I spend on the internet reading about my goal? Finding out more and more information. How much time do I try to speak to people with my who are on my goal? Spend talking to them, meeting them, not meeting them, probably at least talking to them. Talking to them to ho hi sakta hai. How much time do I spend on all that? And make that paradigm shift, my friends, from current, from today to tomorrow. That is the only way we can reach that, identify with our goal. If we make that paradigm shift from today, to tomorrow. If not tomorrow, chalo, one week from now, put in some thoughts and make a shift. Put your time theory into existence and make that shift. Shall we? And then you will reach the goal. That preference, which you can see there, is going towards your road. That is your road. That is going towards your goals. Thank you very much. Anyone wants to say anything?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes. Yeah,
ma'am.
Sorry, my internet is not very good, so probably your voice may the same.
Ma'am, the session is open for Q&A. I invite Bhuma ma'am and Babita ma'am to take over the Q&A session.
Okay, fine.
Yes, Ishan, I'm just opening up the Q&A. Students, if you have any question, please post it on the Q&A section. There is one response which has come. Fuel is the energy to move forward.
Right. Fuel is the energy to move forward. What is the energy for? Why to move forward? Why should I move? If I have the energy, why do I need that energy? That is exactly what, is it a boy or a girl who has written it? That is exactly what the student is saying. Fuel is the energy. Fuel is the why. Only with the fuel can you move ahead. If I know the why, will I move ahead? Otherwise, I will just be sitting stagnant on my chair and do absolutely nothing. Okay. Bhuma ma'am, if there are...
Actually, there are no questions, madam, specifically. Mm-hmm. But of them...
Sorry?
One student asked for winning. Fuel is the energy. But then this one response winning. And students have written again will and skill. If you have a skill, then automatically will be generated for the work.
Okay. I would just like to add, I'm not saying it's incorrect, but sometimes what we have seen a number of times is a lot of people, they collect a lot of skills. They keep studying a lot on different types of skills. But unless they have that will to actually do something about it, I'll keep sitting on my skills and doing nothing. I'll have the skill to keep on upgrading myself. Kyun? Sab log kar rahe karke, even I will keep doing many skills. I will learn photography. I will learn all the latest skills I can learn, all the latest skills currently. I can learn how to do speed reading. I can learn photography. I can learn how to conduct a meditation session. I can learn, okay, suppose I take these three only. I just took photography, a meditation skill, and speed reading. Agreed? If I take these three skills, but if I don't implement it, if I do not have the will to implement it, how will I identify with the goal? Today, when I pick up a book, I read it fast. I have learned how to read it fast. So I'm able to use that skill. I've also learned the importance of meditation, how much it calms the mind and brings you to a level where you're able to be level-headed and calm throughout. Whereas on the other hand, if I just attended any Vipassana course or any meditation course that is going on currently and done nothing about, but being that same reactive person, getting angry at the drop of a hat, fighting with everyone, reacting to everything in life, I do not think am I using the meditation. No, I'm not using it. So it is very, very important. What that student said is perfectly right. Skill, yes. But I also feel that if you have the will, you will use those skills. I'm sorry to put will more above skills, but somehow that is what I usually feel. If you have the will, then you will put everything else into place. Bhuma, anything else?
Hello.
Yes.
Can I ask a question?
Of course.
Yeah. Could you please tell us, ma'am, what is the difference between goal, aim, objectives? Students, I found the students are quite confused regarding these words.
A goal is something like I just said. It is something that you identify yourself with. Okay. What is the meaning of aim? Let's take it a very, very simple meaning of aim. What is the meaning of aim? आप लोगों ने नाम रखा तरकश, तरकश से वो बाण निकाला, उसको क्या किया? एम लगाया, बराबर है? I have to aim towards that goal.
Yes.
I have to aim towards becoming that person. I have to aim towards becoming that sculptor. I have to aim towards becoming that painter. I have to aim towards becoming that photographer, the best photographer. I have to aim towards that. Whereas the goal is the person I identify, the final one. Goal is final, uske beech mein. I have to aim towards going, walking on that road. Correct? Objective? Objective, what is objective? Why? Kyun rakhna hai goal bhai? Do I want a goal? Yes, you want a goal. But why? Answer that question, why? You can say it's a process. What you all have very rightly said, children, it's a process that you all have done out for yourselves. Objective, aim, goal. Upar rakho, goal ko. First you start with objective, you go towards aim, and then you reach goal. Perfect process you all have outlined. Very good friends, I would say.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, there's another question that has come up.
Yeah, sure.
The question says that along with my studies, I give. Okay, I'm a first year student, but I'm confused about two things in which I have an interest and see growth in it. But what do I pursue? Along with my studies, I give private skating classes and I have a startup as well. And with my studies, I cannot handle both. How do I sort myself from this? This is a question that has been asked now.
Actually, I would like to say that when you have started out the question itself, you have said, along with my studies, I do private teaching and I have a startup, right? Was that the way the
student says that the student has got a startup and also skating classes is what is written here.
Okay, the person is teaching skating or is going for skating.
Yeah, what I give private skating classes and I have a startup as well. So along mm-hmm. with my studies, how can I handle both? And how do I sort myself?
I'll tell you one thing. If you remember that picture of that man holding his five fingers, what is primary for you? Your studies is primary at the moment? The skating classes are important or your startup is important. Give it a little bit of thought. Don't think of today. Money will come from your skating classes. The money will come from your startup. But what is it? Will this also hold 5 years from now? Think about it. The decision you take, the consequences you bear, Shweta is speaking, right? the decisions you take.
Yeah, ma'am. I'm just sharing the questions that the students are putting up in the chat.
It's okay, Shweta. I just wanted to just find out. So the decisions you take today will have long-term effects. So think, remember that man with the five fingers. What is primary for you of all these three? कौन सा चीज प्राइमरी है, कौन सी चीज को मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट दोगे तुम लोग, इंपॉर्टेंस दोगे? बेस्ड ऑन दैट देन यू आइडेंटिफाई योर गोल. इज योर स्टार्टअप द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग फॉर यू? फाइन, पुट ऑल योर फोकस, पुट ऑल योर एनर्जी, पुट ऑल योर एंथुसियाज्म इनटू योर स्टार्टअप. स्केटिंग कुड कम सेकंड. हैव दैट गोल वर्सेस टाइम थियोरी. दिस इज द टाइम when you need that, my dear friend, whoever asks this question, put those questions. 1, 2, 3, education, startup, skating class. How much hour on each do you spend today? Is this the way you want it for another 5 years, another 10 years? If not, make that paradigm shift. Do have it going if you feel like, but in terms of hours, you can reduce, kam jada, depending on how you want it going for yourself. Everyone has to have a primary focus in life. We all have. The professors in your college have. Everyone has. The principal, the professors, your director, everyone, all of them, your managing committee, they all have a primary focus in life. The SIA college is supreme. It's very, very important of primary focus for them. They put a lot of time, energy into that. And the others, they put second, third, probably. Correct? I hope I've answered the question to the satisfaction of that student.
Yes, ma'am. Actually, there is one more question.
Ma'am, there are, I think,
few more questions are there. Okay. One is how to deal with failure.
How to deal with failure? Today we are talking about goals, Bhuma. This is a question from a student. I can take it offline, but on a one-to-one basis.
Okay.
Then probably the number is shared out there. That will be better if I take it on a one-to-one basis. Okay. Because today the focus, today my primary focus is on Lakshya and goals. If you fail in your goals, how do you do it? Is that the question?
Probably.
Or is it just how do I face failure? There are two different things. Is it failure in your goal or is it failure in generic or in your life? What is the question?
It's a generic question, how to deal with failure.
Okay, then I would like to take it offline, Bhuma, if it's okay.
Yeah, ma'am.
If it was failure with goals, probably we could have discussed it here. But if it's a generic question, we would discuss it offline.
Yeah, one more question is how to identify the right path in this world where everyone is in a rat race to find a good job.
How to identify the right path? Is this to identify a goal for yourself?
Yes.
Okay. For that, I would say is first of all, consider your aptitude. Consider the potential that you have. Everyone is born with some skill. Find out that skill. That a person who can help you with finding out the skill you have can be your friends. Actually speaking, when friends get together and sit down, you know, friends actually kabhi kabhi pastime bhi hota hai, lekin kabhi kabhi they give the best of advice. If you see a group of friends, they say, "Arey, tu to isme bahut acha hai yaar, tu ye kyun nahi karta hai?" Some friends give that advice or no? So find out your best skill, find out what you are best suited to do, find out your aptitude, first of all. And giving you that advice can be your friends, can be an aptitude test, can be the seniors in your college, can be from your family or from the other families, means your father's friend, your mother's friend, can be anyone. Today, as students, you all should be open to taking advice. When you all ask for it, by the way, na baki log to hamesha gyan to dete hi rehte hain. So when you ask for it, be ready to take advice. If people tell you, no, you're good at this, I think you can make a career of this, take that. Somebody may tell you something else, five people may tell you something else, but out of that five people's opinions, there will be, believe me, there will be at least two that are similar. All five will not be in five directions. There will be at least two that are similar. That will be your basic skill that they are seeing in you, the aptitude they are seeing in you.
Ma'am,
based on that, yeah,
no. Yes, ma'am.
Once you know your basic skill, once you know the potential that you have within you, and there are some things in life that you like to do. Ek achha lagta hai karne ko, kuch to, you know. Rat race wagera to chalte rehta hai. Is it not possible? The thing for how many IIT seats you all have, friends? Final IIT seats kitne hote hain? I do not know. How many children appear for it? Does everyone have the capacity for an IIT? Capacity hai, definitely sit, make your, go for it, think about it. Logical conclusions, it should be a very, very thought about process. Speak to seniors, speak to your seniors in college, speak to your family, speak to your friends. Family mein, arre pata nahi. So your friends are always there to guide you. Ask your friends, speak to one another. And once you're in the rat race, you'll say, arre, my God, why am I in the rat race, you know? First of all, have a goal which gives you happiness. Most important, if you'll remember, the car gives you happiness. The first slide, your goal gives you happiness in life. When the sculptor is making a sculpture, he's happy. When the chef is making the best of cuisines, that person is happy. When that engineer is standing and civil engineer is standing and he's designing or he's drafting or drawing, it makes him happy. It makes him happy. It gives him revenue. Makes him happy, revenue, growth to hona hi hona hai. Hona hai ki nahi hona hai? Hota hai na? Aaj nahi to kal hona hi hona hai lekin. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, there is one more, it's a statement, probably also a question. I can't focus on one goal. I have confusion to select. How to deal, probably.
That's okay. All of us have that, no? Sometimes. We have 1, 2, 3 goals. You are still young. Out of that 1, 2, 3 goals that you have, keep looking at that list in front of you. Keep seeing one that really resonates with you, really. You feel very strongly, yes, this is what I want to do in life. This is my primary goal. Baki sab to chalta hi rehta hai. I'm not saying no. Look at me also. I'm an author. I'm a psychologist also. And I was backed by HR experience. So today I have two different goals where I'm working at. I'm also a speaker. I speak also. So it's okay. But it is something which it gives you happiness. It makes you feel correct. Ki, this is me. Karke. Out of those 1, 2, 3, all, you will not feel 1, 2, 3, sabhi ke sab equal hai. That is a little, I don't know, probably a little far-fetched to believe. I'm making a mistake. Ho sakta hai. I do not know. But from what I have seen, with my knowledge and with my experience as a psychologist also, we usually feel there is one thing that a person feels very strong, he resonates very, very strongly towards. Make that the first. Baki do bhi rakho. Aisa nahi ki chhod do usko. Baki do bhi rakho. It can be second and third. The time you spend on one can be little lesser on two and a little lesser on three. So you have all three running. But you should have the capacity, you should have the potential. Correct, friends?
Yes, ma'am. There is one more question that has come up. what to do when we are confused or not sure about the choices we make.
I think we just discussed that, no?
Yeah, sounds similar.
Yeah, because we said that aptitude and your potential and the choice of a race your career counselor and all would have for you.
Yes. There is one more thing, one more question. Should I have bigger goals like what I want to do with my life, or can I have smaller goals like achieving something in this week or months?
To start off with, to have that feeling of success, what I would suggest is have smaller goals. Have a small goal to just give you a feeling of success. Once you identify, once that thing happens for you, then you know you can say, yes, I did it. Feeling of success comes, a feeling of, I got it, man. You know, you get that feeling. So sometimes it's better to have a little, not weekly, I would say a monthly goal, which you can identify with. Have a monthly goal. Success, you know, you'll feel successful, you'll feel happy, and you'll go on to your next goal. You'll set a quarterly goal, you'll set a yearly goal. That is the stepping stone. This question is a very perfect question, actually. The student who asks this is perfect on the dot.
There is question which has come up. I am 20 years old, but working with a big firm and at higher position, and still looking for working with same interests. But if I have to complete my study, for that I have to take a leave from work. So what should I do?
So do you want to complete your studies? I think you want to, no? I think the student wants to complete the studies, right? But can you not apply for leave? Usually organizations these days give for leave for studies and all that. I don't think it should be a challenge. In fact, organizations encourage people studying and working together. They give you flexi time. I do not know. It's not so much prevalent. But however, giving of leave and all that is usually encouraged. That for a 20-year-old, yes, definitely, it should not be a challenge. Be prepared, probably, if they say that we cannot give you leave, paid leave, be prepared to go on unpaid leave. For that is one thing that I'll have to be prepared for. There are some things I also need to give if I need to do something. So be prepared, my friend. If the company says we cannot give you such a long leave, but we are willing to keep you, but you'll have to go on unpaid leave. You say, okay, fine, that's fair with me. But show that your studies matter to the organization.
Ma'am, one more thing is, since I want to join army, should I pursue new skills apart from my studies and preparation for CDS exams and SSB interview?
To the best of my knowledge, I cannot say I have much knowledge on this, but to the best of my knowledge, what I have been told is, for Army, they have that Army Training Academy. And usually people who train for Army, from what I have seen, is they always join your NCC and all those in school and college and all that. So they have a basic level of training which is happening all throughout their education, you know. So they are always kind of physically more fit and agile. They are tuned to be mentally disciplined and physically agile. So when they enroll for this in school and in college, y'all are all in college, but when they enroll for their NCCs in college also, they are kind of trained to be physically agile and physically fit and mentally agile, which is a great asset when you want to join the army, which is a must, I would say, because you all know the kind of conditions the army works under. We have seen enough WhatsApp videos to know that how tough a life our army is going through. For that, you need physical and mental agility.
And one question is, ma'am, I want to do a job after graduation to support my family, but mostly people suggest me to pursue higher education, further higher studies. What should I do?
The notion is very, very good. I would say the student has a very very good and a very noble suggestion that he wants to support his family. But these days, you have something called as part-time education for higher studies. You have part-time education, flexi education. You have all those facilities also, no? Weekend colleges, Saturday, Sunday, and all that. For MBAs also, MBA colleges are also Saturday, Sundays. Not all the days of the week. So it can be done if you want to.
Yes, ma'am. Final question is,
yeah,
I'm 19 years old. I have two goals. I want to concentrate on dancing. I'm dancing since 9 years, and I have to concentrate on banking. In which goal should I concentrate?
And why do you feel that you want to concentrate on banking? Why does a student feel that he or she wants to concentrate on banking? Dancing is an excellent career in today's time. Every function, every festival that you see, people are dancing away to the glory. I think choreographers make more money than anyone else, right? And dancing is a very, very artistic skill, not probably which everyone can acquire. Or you can be a banker as a profession and keep dancing as a hobby for yourself, as a passion which you drive at, like I did with my writing. I kept writing continuously. You can do both like that. I would say that if you have been dancing since 9 years old, you could make that your primary focus. However, if there are other thoughts in the family that you could be a banker, I do not want to get into that arena. You could be a banker, but then continue your dancing skill. If you're dancing since 9 years old, friend, you're putting a lot of time and effort into that. Don't let that time and effort go waste. Use it. Use that will that pushed you to dance. Use that skill that you have acquired since 9 years old. That's a lot of time and effort you have put in. Use it to the full. You'll be able to manage it. Fine?
Yes, ma'am. That's the last question on the Q&A. Ishan, okay. I request you to take over.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much. It was a great session talking to students today. Thank you, seniors of the college. Thank you, Bhuma, for coordinating all this. And the IT team. You'll have a great IT team. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Ma'am, my voice is audible?
Yes.
Can I leave?
Yeah, ma'am.
Can I leave the same?
No, ma'am. Just wait for 5 minutes.
Okay.
The road to your dreams isn't always easy to navigate. Sometimes dotted with mountains to climb, obstacles to overcome, and hard mind, numbing times that will make you feel quitting. Ma'am, through all your examples, we could understand the importance and process of goal setting. Thank you, ma'am. It was good to have you here today. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ishan. Thank you for the kind words. You're great. Thank you. I really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, just a small request. Can you switch on your video and other teachers just to take a pic? Hello.
Yeah, I've switched on my camera.
Yeah.
Still.
Can you stop screen sharing so that it will be easy to take? Jyoti, ma'am, your screen is not visible. Your photo. Your camera.
Now is it visible?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I had a great time. Thank you, friends.
Thank you, ma'am.
should I leave the sync?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you bring on another speaker?
Yes, yes. Shankar sir would be joining shortly. नेक्स्ट टीम टू टेक ओवर प्लीज.
मैडम शंकर सर का आईडी क्या है? आरपी
आरपी 2 है
सर. इज ऑलरेडी
अभी तक ज्वाइन नहीं हुए शायद.
नहीं नहीं सर इज देयर ऑलरेडी ऑन स्क्रीन सर. इट इज अलॉटेड अंडर उर्मी शेतिया.
ओके ओके ओके
दैट्स मी.
यस
ब्रिज बिटवीन सेशंस.
आप लाइव है अभी?
यस आई एम लाइव. द इवेंट इज रॉकिंग एंड रोलिंग. आई थिंक इट्स तर्कश 2021 द 21st सेंचुरी स्किल सेशन मे 18th ओरिजिनली स्लॉटेड फॉर 11:15. वी आर जस्ट 30 मिनट्स बिहाइंड टाइम बट आई एम श्योर वी कैन कैच अप.
जस्ट अ स्मॉल अनाउंसमेंट बिफोर वी स्टार्ट विद सेशन 2. Students, those who have joined the session, all the attendees, please try to rename yourself. So when you put up your questions on the chat box, it's all anonymous. So if you could rename yourself, we can address you directly. The speaker would be more than happy to take your questions and, you know, solve your queries. So please try to rename yourself. And with that, I request Swarangi Maharao to introduce our guest for today. Swarangi?
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, Varan. Go ahead, please.
Yeah. Hello, everyone. A very warm welcome to all of you. Thank you for joining with us, Tarkash Road to Success. I'm privileged to extend my warm welcome. I'm Swarangi Maharao, today's host for second session of the day. Skill is unified force of experience, intellect, and passion in their operation. Rightly said by John Ruskin. Now in this competitive era, not just marks, but practical skills are also very crucial stepping stone in our career. So exactly to guide us on this subject matter, skills of 21st century, we have Mr. Shankar Rajgopal sir with us. Yesterday, when I was going through his profile, I was just astonished by seeing his diverse expertise in the field. Sir is a chemical engineer from BITS Pilani and MBA from University of Indianapolis, starting his career with Ghada Chemicals, Asian Paints, Tata Projects, Dr. Reddy's from Pharma, and now working in Sterling and Wilson Solar. Sir has gained around 36 years of experience as a quality, safety, sustainability, business excellence, process improvement, and change management professional. A first member of CSR Advisory Board with IPE, Core Committee and ESSER at EHS, and Sustainability Awards with CII, and won endless awards and achievements till now. Also, he has been speaker at IPE, CII, FICCI, and many other platforms. I feel that we are so blessed to have just a talented and versatile personality with us. Now, without any further ado, let's listen to Mr. Shankar Rajgopal sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Swarangi, for the lovely introduction. I feel 80 years old after the long list of things you read, but thank you so much. It's a pleasure and privilege to be at this platform. At the outset, like everyone is thanked IT, but is somebody going to run my presentation? It's shared. You can see the presentation somewhere there. I hope one of you will be running it. I tried sharing it from my desktop. I'm unable to do that for some reason. Perhaps I'm MacBook Pro enabled or disabled. So yeah, super. I can see something is happening. Thank you, Swarangi. Beautiful. That sounds good. So I guess this is a session on 21st century skills, and I must compliment the entire team of Tarkash. I'll start with the lovely organizing committee, all the people on the call, Surangi, Ishan, Kishan, Tarun, Hema, and all the people who said such wonderful things in the last couple of hours. I've been on the call since before we went live. It's been very interesting. I never seen such an engaging stuff at all. So compliments to Team Sia for a fantastic workshop. It looks beautiful. I can only wait. If it's well begun, it's half done. I think you're on your way, right? Thank you so much. So on these slides, just a quick check. We got a time slot from 11:15 to 12:30, and I guess we almost could hit 12:30 by the time we do the introductions. So when I make a small sound like this, you can change the slide, okay? Yeah, that's the cue for the slide shift. You can move to the next slide.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. Now, if you want me to finish by 12:30, you will have to be running the slides faster than I speak, okay? If that is possible.
Yes, sure, sir.
Okay, you can try your best on that. So, a big hand to the faculties, the principals, Mrs. Padmaja Arvind for having hosted the sponsor of this session. Also very good to hear from the guest of honor, Ramesh. I think it took us through. We can keep changing the slides as we speak when I do this movie. That's a cue to the next slide. I hope there are more slides. Okay, there you go. Can you keep it on full screen? Control L if possible. Or a full screen, is it possible? It's a PDF, you can do a control L, it'll be full screen. Okay, it's a PDF, that means animations won't work. Okay, fair enough. So welcome teams here. And as a pause, how are we managing in the times of the pandemic, the heat waves and the storms? Yeah, I think the cyclone must have been pretty devastating yesterday. I saw some pictures of some of the colleges in Mumbai and the campus where the trees have kind of blown down. I hope this has been not so difficult time for the Sia College of Higher Education. I hope all of you are doing well and managing to stay safe amidst the pandemic. It's not yet time for the vaccine, but I hope and pray that you'll be good. So can we do this? Are the slides okay? People on the call, would you like to see it in a different way? Would you like to do a page view? How would you like to do it? Can't you run the presentation? Swarangi, the PowerPoint might be good.
Sir, I'll just share the PowerPoint to them.
Okay, that'll be useful because this will be slightly difficult to navigate for the team. Okay, so good. So the session was very interesting, the last one, and talking of the 80-20 principle, I thought the people who are 80 years old get to hog 80% of the time, and the youngsters who are 20 years old get 20% of the time, but I think it's the reverse way. I think I should make and factor in a longer slot for the question and answers, but I really loved the questions. Feel free in case you're locked in anonymously and you can't kind of don't want to leave the session for a minute and come back. Please pop in your name when you ask the question, so that'll be as good as it gets, right? Thank you so much for that. But interesting learnings from Jyoti ji, and I like that the car, the fuel, the driver and the direction. Now, which car do you want? Good question. I just was in Dubai for a couple of years, and I think the best car there is almost, the best car in India is the taxi of Dubai. So the Toyota Corolla could be one of the premium cars.
Sorry to disturb. Swarangi, tumhara sharing chalu karo. Sharing band ho gaya.
Yeah.
Sir, slide.
Yeah, go ahead. Please share. Feel free to share. All this needs to be shared. Also needs to be recorded as suggested. Yeah, so talking of goals and directions.
Sir, sorry to interrupt. Swarangi, I've shared the PPT on your this one, WhatsApp. Please, you can share it with sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Or you want me to run, I can run from this end.
Okay, ma'am, no problem. You can share.
Yeah.
That would be nice. I think that's the best thing. The one skill that you should learn, boys and girls, is delegation. And the best form of delegation is upward delegation, right? When you run out of ideas, don't know what to do, escalate to your boss and let the boss take over. So thank you, Guma. for being a savior for all of us. Yeah, so talking of cars, I had this thought of, you know, buying a big swanky car when you go elsewhere. And then this time in India, where you could see most of the car companies are struggling to sell cars. Why? Are the fuel prices down? Are they high? Are they peaking? What's happening? So it's a change scenario. I think the last couple of years saw a different direction in the car park, the vehicles park in the country, where you can see the Ubers and the Olas have kind of taken over, the model has taken over, and people whose ambition was, you know, ek acha car hona chahiye, acha bangla hona chahiye, and then of course Asian Paints follows, but no longer want to buy a car. They would continue being bekar in this time. So I hope that also gives a good context on this. So while you're on the slides, Bhuma, I'll run a slight small story. This story, I think, goes with Tarkash. Yeah, that's lovely. That's beautiful. That's better, right? So you can go to slide 1, 2, and then 3. Yeah. So compliments on Tarkash. Folks on the call, it's been fantastic. The skills for the 21st century is the theme today. Go ahead. I will do this nice noise, Bhuma. Every time I got a stopwatch here, every time I turn it, you can hear the sound. You can change the slide. So Tarkash, and welcome to the team once again, and hope that in spite of all the uncertainties in the future, and I hope the last session give you a lot of feeders, will give you some context into how to manage in the big bad world. Go ahead. Next. Yeah, so that's a pause. And like they say that there's animations here, so you can keep clicking. Yeah. The question to all of us, as you sit in various places at homes, at offices, at college rooms, are you sitting comfortably and working ergonomically? A lot of people, the first factor they had was the pants got crumpled, but you got to give your back a break. And it's all about sitting comfortably and ensuring that you give your L5, L6 support, give your neck support, the cranial support, sit on a nice chair, you know, keep your legs and knees at a 90 degree angle. And of course, in the times of the pandemic, keep the distance, wash your hands, wear your mask, everybody, be safe. Yes. So that's a PAUSE, which stands for pause, plan and use safety every day. So it's a pandemic paradox, all right. I don't know how many of you could read the red letter on the wall, but this says that which is the world that we want, and we come out of the pandemic, and maybe we can speak about this more in sessions that follow. Do we want to get back to the new normal? Perhaps we do, but perhaps we do not want to get back to the normal, because normal was the problem perhaps. So that again is the biggest paradox in life. And all of you have suffered the pandemic. Some part of your education has been virtual, and I guess that's not the best way to really teach. But we survived all that, right? So I think stay firm, stay safe. So what is the world we want? The friendly reflections in the time of the confinement. Yeah, go ahead. So I guess, so this is my story. You can kind of click, click, click. So the pandemic progress, I have been locked down in various continents. I was in Oman in November 2019, went into India in January, went into Dubai in February, then went into Australia. I was in Sydney, Wellington for around 6-8 months. I got locked down, came back, been into Africa. So that's been my kind of quest there. It's been a difficult challenge. And now this is the first time in life that I am currently at Hyderabad locked down. So it's an interesting phase in life. I know it's difficult to be locked down and pursue various, we spoke about all the quests about dancing and the various things that we spoke about. Somewhere it is difficult, so I understand this is tough. Go ahead. So how do we cope with the corona? So I managed this way by doing a lot of webinars. Keep going. Yeah. Bhuma, you got to finish it by 12:45 lunchtime. Okay, there you go. The seminar sessions. So I've been kind of into, you know, a lot of, I used my time gainfully. So what did I learn in the lockdown? I learned to do webinars, to connect virtually and kind of coach, teach, learn, and also implement stuff like carbon footprinting virtually. Go ahead. So, and also, of course, I become a kind of serial killer using MS Team, which was one of the liberating forces for connecting organizations. Like I mentioned, sitting in Australia, I could connect with teams across the globe, get them to, you know, do the carbon emission scope 1, scope 2, scope 3, if you're aware of what it is, and then finally make our company green, carbon neutral as we speak. Okay, so that's the story of my pandemic learnings. Go ahead. The cause of death is webinar. That's the killing. Go ahead. So that's the ABCD of the pandemic. You can see that each of these is relevant, and wherever you are, be it in Mumbai or wherever it is, please avoid the crowd. Let's test the audio, Bhuma, if possible. Let's see the video plays, and maybe you'll get a context of one of the humorists of our time. You can click on that, and the ultimate authority on the pandemic. If your sound's up, let's try and see the video works. Yeah, go ahead, click if possible. No, I don't think the sound works. Yeah, is it working? Check the sound once, it just might be useful. Okay, doesn't matter. Forget it. Go ahead. Go to the next slide. Doesn't matter. Don't worry about the sound. It's a video that talks about Dr. Fauci and starting from the pandemic.
What is coronavirus so different?
Okay, that's good.
Because, you know, when people used to ask me over the years, what is it that I most worry about with regard to emerging infectious diseases, is a respiratory-borne illness that easily spreads from person to person, mm-hmm. but that has a high degree of morbidity and mortality. And unfortunately, that's the worst nightmare you could have, is to have something like that. I mean, there are other diseases. Ebola was frightening, but Ebola gets transmitted only when you're in very close contact with a person who is very, very ill. With this disease, in some respects similar to influenza, but in some respects very different, it spreads very easily. You can spread it when you're not symptomatic. So it's insidious and treacherous in that you could spread it easily. The other part about it that's really so different from anything that we've ever faced before is that if you look at the mortality of seasonal flu, the thing that you and I go through every season, mm-hmm. the mortality is about 0.1%. That's a lot. And we get used to that morbidity and mortality. But the mortality of this is about 10 times that. It's at least 1%. So it's a disease that not only is easily spread, but it can be devastating, particularly for a certain subset of the population, demographically different. The elderly, those with underlying conditions, heart disease, mm-hmm. lung disease, mm-hmm. diabetes. It can be very serious for them with a high degree of mortality.
Let's talk a little bit about the information in and around corona that's I think, getting people confused. I see so many conflicting ideas online, and I guess the horrible byproduct of having social media and the internet is everyone is now an expert and everyone has an opinion. I know this is very basic for you, but just to help everyone be on the same page, how can we catch corona and what are the areas we should be most concerned about? So we know about human-to-human transmission. Most people understand that, but I see people online worried about grocery shopping, touching packages that they receive from Amazon. Do people need to wipe them down when they're in the grocery store? Can they touch other things? How long does coronavirus last in the air? For instance, if you walk into an elevator after somebody else, can coronavirus still be there? What do we need to be on the lookout for as individuals?
Okay, there's varied degrees of risk, Trevor, of that in every respect. But the things that are the most common that you really want to latch on to is that sneezing and coughing. When someone is ill, they've got to...
That's fine. You could go ahead. Yeah, that's okay. Switch to the next slide. So we can see that this has been a challenging time, and I can say, and not all of you would be eligible for the vaccination. I luckily had the vaccine, both the doses last year, but this is important for us to realize that we can never be careful. Is my sound okay?
Yes, sir, you're audible. Perfect.
So what's day zero of Tarkash commemorate? Yeah, what is it? Day zero, when was that? May 17th, go ahead. Yeah, so that was the quiz we had for you guys. I think all of you got it. You could switch, go back, one slide back. Yeah, so that was a quiz we had unleashed for the real simple Tarkash 2021 quiz. And that was on May 17th, day zero. On what was the occasion on May 17th and the cryptic clues that we had there. That was the integrated reporting framework, a song cover of the band Carpenters, some intrepid explorers, and we talked of dancing and various other skills, but hourglass figure, the girl, the beautiful girl with the hourglass figure, and this is a character that you might not have heard of, but Elon Musk, is it Tesla, what is it? And of course, fun with So go ahead. So I think this was May 17th, and you know that these 3 days are good, exciting days of Tarkash, but what was the day zero commemorate? And if you're still online, would like to take a shot at the answer, you can pop it in the chat box, you can unmute and tell us what your thoughts are. Otherwise, the answer will be broken in a couple of seconds. Yeah, that's your calendar, the academic calendar. You can see that you've got birthdays all around, Mahavir Jayanti and all that. But Tarkash 2021 starts today and 17th was. Go ahead. Yeah, so day zero of Tarkash is the National Day of Norway. It's an official public holiday observed on the 17th of each year amongst Norwegians. It's called various things. It's called the Sinten de Mai, 17th May, also called in the Norse code Nas John Tajen or Grunlov again. It's the anniversary of the constitution commemorating the independence from Denmark 2006 years ago. And here are some of the clues that demystified the first company to publish and spoke about the triple bottom line, the environmental, social and governmental report. It's also a song called the Norwegian Wood. And of course, the explorers are Roald Amundsen, the kind of people you heard of, all Vikings. Marilyn Monroe was the lady who was also suspected Norwegian. Elon Musk's son's name, if you notice what it was, is a Norse character, the alphabet that is used there. It's also a game that is used. And also, this is the game that you saw in the slide was being used there. So May 17th is also, like people say, the World Endangered Species, Hypertension, Anti-AIDS Day. And also, I guess, the birthday of very famous people. Yeah, who are the famous people who were born on this day? Any guesses? I think Boma will speak about Mr. Vardhan, her father, birthday yesterday. Also the birthday of Adi Shankaracharya, the saint who, you know, many, many years ago, he's a guy who traversed the country on foot. And also the star birthday of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. So apologies for taking that. So that's the answer to the quiz. Also about connecting. Also, guess, boys and girls on the call, what's the profile? So this is the person who's got a global profile, global outreach, hobbies. You see that he's a proven change agent, has delivered cultural transmissions, real, we talked about the future skills you need, delivered digital, the global digital transformation. I spoke about greenhouse gas emissions, reduce the carbon emissions. Yeah, any idea? Friends, you could chat, put it in the pop box, unmute and give the answer. Who is this? Whom am I introducing here? Any thoughts? Yeah, so that's the answer. That's the profile, the resume of COVID-19. And all of you put up nice profiles and put up CVs. And this is the time when you really flesh them out. But this is the answer to what is something that's happened across. Yeah. And the basic human needs has changed from what it was, from roti, kapda or makan, as it was in the past, to that nirvana, self-actualization. I think we spoke about that pyramid. We heard about what's important. A will or skill, as I say, as you grow higher in the hierarchy, you need more of will. As you go down the ladder, you need a little bit of skill to empower yourself. But currently everyone, especially after the last 2 years of cyclone, needs a strong Wi-Fi. There's a battery power outage. You need battery. And of course, the face mask is what everyone needs starting from getting up in the morning. They say that's also mandated to use a double face mask and also use at home. Yeah. So that's me in a small nutshell. I think you read through it. Go ahead. Yeah, that's my other career work life. So I'll just pause here and I'll also try and tell you that you might be in various streams. You might be in various functions and various roles, but you know, the next step that happens could be largely different, and this destiny that can take you anywhere. Yeah. Next slide, please. Yeah, so that's my career path, and you can see that began in various roles and has spanned across 80 years, as we said, and got me to various places across the continent. Yeah, you can keep going. I'll keep with the, yeah. So that's my schooling and background. I was a Xaverite, was in BITS Pilani. That's my first boss, Dr. Garda, the ultimate technologist. He's in UDCT, the ICT now. I was in Asian Paints, mascot was Gattu, and was in Castrol. I kind of came to fame. I got John Abraham to wear a helmet, Rahul Dravid to wear a seatbelt, and Harsha to start with a pause. Was the head of quality assurance in Castrol, went to BP, did a tech role in taking up a wind turbine farm, did supply and distribution modules, did new product development, did de bono, you can say, was in various platforms in Dr. Reddy's, in healthcare, in SR, in a refinery, setting up Hospira in a work life. So that's my work life snapshot. The last couple of roles I was managing quality, safety, sustainability, process improvements, business excellence at Tata Projects, and lately in Sterling Solar. So that's my various hats I wear. You can see that It's been like, I've been all around the place. I've done many, many things. And did I plan this? Like, I think the question that all of you will be asking, and I think you asked questions to Jyoti also, is what will I do next? What will be the next steps there? My suggestion to you is don't worry too much. Just go with the flow. I'm sure whatever skills you have, hone it, harness it, but it will come through well. So kind of don't worry about it, keep going, yeah? And that's the backdrop. I'm in Hyderabad, that's my family, and that's my, we wanted a baby girl, we got a dog, and that's the Rolling Stones. You can see that the Rolling Stones is one of the bands that I've been associated with, and that's me in the center there of the Rolling Stones. So in life also, keep running, and that's the marathons I've run. Some in India, the Mumbai Marathon, and some in London, and one in Sydney. So keep running and keep rolling on. So that's the message, the moral behind all this. So I can talk of some journey towards business excellence in a few steps and some salient learnings. And I think the journey of many miles begins with, a single step. So that's the step we've taken today. So thank you, friends, for taking this step towards a plunge. This workshop is to enable you to get to the next steps of the journey. Go ahead. So I'll talk of the three mistakes of a life. It's my favorite movie and a favorite book also, Chetan Bhagat's life cycle case study of, IB and myself. Yeah. Keep going. So my first job was in Garuda Chemical, like I said, and the effect was to get into zero defects, and there's a master chef that I follow, but also how did we succeed? And I'm trying to talk through some experiential learnings that might help you. The lessons learned from various things I've done might be good for us to also learn, while I can give some theory on what are the skills one needs to have, starting from the way I began and how you project yourself, how you connect, how you use the platform. I heard Boma say that, use LinkedIn, use Facebook, use Instagram, try and connect, establish a connect, get a good network. But this is also the important bit to how you project what you've done. Yeah, so this one talks about how, when there was success in the shop floor, we celebrated, and we celebrated success by, having this. I don't know if you've seen this. It's a bhajia, a gota, a bonda, what you call it, which part of the country you are in. It could be a vada pav, it could be a that kind of stuff there. This is a success story, is celebrated in a big way on special occasions. But my life skills learning for us here is, don't wait for a big occasion. Don't postpone the celebrations. Celebrate success as it is, at the shop floor, at the occasion, at the college, at home, whenever it is, at the moment. So when you've done something good with somebody, has achieved some milestone, celebrate success. Each small step that you have will get you further in. So that's my one learning here. Be spontaneous, don't program success, okay, and celebration. So my second stint was in manufacturing, and it's about a plant where you could, have a dirty shop floor where you had, like I said, paint all spilled and all. So the first thing we did was we made the paint floor very clean. We painted it all white. And the reason we did that was, something stands out. Sometimes you tend to hide. We tend to hide what happens. We tend to hide the skeletons in the cupboard, like we say. But importantly, to kind of keep a backdrop that is clear so you can stand out, it's got to be the stark differentiation that happens that is very clearly visible. So we had people spitting pan and kind of chewing stuff and the paint spilling. And we thought if the paint shop is, it was painted a dark blue color, if you convert it to white, what will happen? It will look very dirty. But people realize that it looked dirty, or the pillars, when people used to spit or something, they realize that it'll dirty it up, it should stand out. And that's how we differentiated the colors and made the shop floor fairly clean. Shop floor is quintessentially dirty, but we made it very clean. So how did we get people to comply and do stuff? When you get into the big bad world, you'll have people, you got to get work done from people. At some stage, you'll be managing teams. So also how you get people to, reflect on what's done possible. And in the shop floor, we had a unionized team. Some people were very tough guys, old guys, or the youngster at that time. How do you get people to, deliver norms? There are lots of challenges, lots of things could go wrong. For example, in a typical paint shop, you might have equipment that's under breakdown, you might have finished goods, material not available, pallets not available, pallet trucks, material handling, equipment breakdowns, you've got availability of paint not there, power might break down, n number of reasons why things could not happen. But how do you ensure that you still manage productivity and get the output? As a production engineer on the shift, as a production manager later, one of the things we did was this simple thing. depending on the team that did well, a crew that succeeded in meeting the norm should put a nice, beautiful smiley at that whiteboard where the team came in and do the shift. And the team that didn't do well, a grumpy and an angry face for the team that could not manage the norms or underperformed. Yeah. So in those days where there were no digital dashboards, now there's business analytics. We'll speak about that tomorrow. This is one way of differentiating the and the people really when they should come in, wash their hands at the end of the shift, walk past the shop floor and see their performance. And nothing else, nothing said. You don't say anything, but those visual cues are ones that get them to comply. And productivity, guess what happened? It improved a lot after that. So the life skills learning here in a colorful situation here is try and create dashboards. But in essence, simple lesson, the life skill learning for all of us in whatever you do, create a differentiation between the good, the bad and the ugly. Even at home, at college, at work, try and everyone, if there are two or three kids, if everyone, one guy underperforms, one guy does well, one guy is a good boy, one guy is not. And if you treat them equally, the good boy will feel that there is no point in being good, and the bad guy will say is getting along well without any questions. So it's also about ensuring that you differentiate and create a differentiation through dashboards and stuff is what is important there. So you might have heard of this term called sustainable TQM rollout. TQM in essence is, as I say in Marathi, tumhe kya mila, tujhe kya mila. So TQM is also about how you get people engaged, total employee engagement in creating a sustainable culture where you have the CEO, customer, the employees and the owners engaged together. But this is also a story of how we got people to commit to plans and how you ensured that. So friends, I know that when you have a meeting like today and you have a calendar that comes in your Outlook or into your MS Teams and it pops up a reminder and tells you repeatedly half an hour before, 15 minutes before and 5 minutes before the call that the session is starting, it's time to log in, get connected, or there is some activity that you put on the calendar, be it an Outlook or MS Team. So the way it prompts you, and you can program it the way you want. Likewise, what was done in this particular example in a lubricant blending and refining company, every day of the week was assigned to a particular team. It was block A, block B, manufacturing, supply and distribution quality. Each team came up and spoke about their initiatives. A Kaizen is a small improvement in their own work area. 5S is housekeeping improvement, cleanliness, neatness, orderliness, discipline. And how they did that in a small group was what they discussed. So once we decided the day, each day they turned out. So we made a calendar and everyone came in. They explained what they did in a very interesting way. Of course, it was followed by breakfast and preceded by a prayer. But in the essence in life is whatever good things you learn, be it college or you do virtual learning, try and embed this in your life. You got to make it part of the DNA. In a sense, whatever you do, you got to make it, you got to religiously and diligently, stay with it. Well begun is half done, like they say, most of the work remains that way. You got to make it part of your entire structure there. Yeah, so that's important. There's embed things in a calendar, whatever you do, make it a routine, make it a religion, make it part of an injection that goes in there. So this is a story of India where you heard of the accidents that happen, you heard of the challenges that we have. So this was in a company called BP, where it was about making, driving safety home. So we realized that a lot of the challenges in the trucks, in the vehicles was about, hitting people, and this is how it happened there. So this is a story of how we created a shared vision. This program was done at, that's me, at the Cricket Club of India, the Brabourne Stadium, where we had all the transporters come in, and in a nice inclusive session where we spoke about the statistics of driving, we spoke about when accidents happen. Guess what? It happens late nights, in the span of 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock in the morning, when the circadian rhythm hits in, when the people tend to sleep, it's the high risk area of time. That's where most accidents also happen, where most robberies also happen. So this is where we taught them and coached them and showed them what are the challenges, and we worked towards a shared solution. They got together and said that we will ban night driving for trucks and vehicles, we'll upgrade the vehicles. This is around the time when even vehicles didn't have airbags and seat belts, but this is the trucks. They got trucks upgraded. They got trucks with seat belts. They took ways to change, to train the drivers on defensive driving. We also coached the cool cab drivers of Mumbai to have defensive driving training, to drive anticipating the errors of others, to wear seat belts, to have a risk assessment of journey. And we communicated this by a mnemonic. So look at my fingers if you can. You can see my face there. So we communicated to visual cues. Like one is your vehicle is unsafe, you are unsafe. Two, many passengers, too big a risk. Unsecured load, unsafe journey. Unfit drivers, unfit jar is a unsafe journey. Kunuchwar, fitting and tiredness skills, got to be awake and alert. Using a mobile phone, the number six, yeah? Number six, using a mobile phone causes accidents. Journey risk management, number seven, you've got to plan your journeys. Seat belts save lives, number eight. Drinking and driving kills, use your head, use your helmet. See, in essence, we try to communicate it, and I think it's, you can't tell too many things to people. Maybe five things, 10 things, 10 tenets, you can call it a driving safety. It's also important the process in whatever you do, be it the ISO standards or whatever the expectations you have in life, you got to engage stakeholders in your journey. You got to take them along. You make it inclusive, people will understand the why of what you do and then take the next steps there. So when you want to make a pitch, even if you want a new car, when you go back home, you've been inspired to take a BMW, you got to make a pitch, you got to sell it, you got to market it, you got to explain why that BMW is going to be the most life-changing thing for you. Okay, so that's about it. So this is about creating a shared vision, ensuring stakeholder engagement as journey, life skill journey there. This is an interesting story of a company where I went to in a refinery in Jamnagar, where we used a technique called the six thinking hats. Okay, you must, some of you must have heard this in cricket. I think if you remember, there's a cricket coach called Greg Chappell. He tried using the six thinking hats in the Indian cricket team. He made Sachin Tendulkar open. He made Rahul Dravid also do wicket keeping, and then he made Ganguly's the non-playing captain, which did go well with the Indian cricket team. High egos, people there. But apart from those things, it's also about how they said playing the slog overs first, not just waiting till the last 19th or the 49th over, as it was in the 50 over matches. So it's about putting the things first. So example here is of a refinery where there was a set of people with different characteristics. So I'll talk about one guy and explain the hats in that way. So the guy in the extreme right who was wearing a black hat. So what was his characteristic? Anytime we had a meeting in a refinery, refinery is high scale, it's humongous in terms of anything that can go wrong will have tremendous, the refinery could trip and everything would go down. So he tends to be extra cautious. He would say in every meeting, ye nahi hoga, ye pura barbaad kar doge, ye pura jala doge refinery, ko trip ho jayega, iska productivity nahi aayegi, chalega hi nahi. Yeah? You can guess that he was not very popular, but then what was he doing, friends? He was wearing the black hat of caution and identify how things could go wrong. In life, with every step we take, we also got to identify what can go wrong. I'll talk about that in a couple of seconds, but it's very important as a role in any meeting, in every group, in every kind of cross-functional team that you have, friends, you got to have different hats. If the principal says yes, and you all say yes, it's not so good. Somebody's got to stand up and say why, and say it nicely. And that's why you wear the black hat and say that this is my thought. So it's about wearing various hats. The white hat looks at facts, understanding the data. The red hat looks at feelings, go with the heart. It's about the head, heart, and the gut sometimes. The yellow looks at the benefits. The green hat is out of the box, creativity. So what was done here, and the head of the refinery was the guy who wore the blue hat, who ensured, between all these people, you ultimately got to drive the process. You got to have an outcome. So various elements of the typical, what's called the process elements, was driven by various functional leads, where you got people to kind of get in and wear various hats and do things. And the learnings out here for the life skills, for the skills, for the children out here graduating, the boys and girls, is think out of the box, be different. Yeah, wear a different hat each time. Don't stay with the same kind of dull, drab, dreary hat you're wearing. Try and be different, try and reinvent, try and do something different there. Yeah, that's Edward Deboer of the six thinking hats. So this is also about health. This is important, that is advancing wellness day by day. So this is about a theme in Dr. D's, where the entire speech was about wellness, and the company's logo and the theme kind of was about good health, can't wait, but how we yoke onto wellness, how we created a platform by which people understood that this is important. The tomorrow, for example, is Wednesday. We called it Wellness Day, okay? And this is about positioning. So importantly, I think we also heard this in the morning session. It's about brand positioning, good health, great life. It's also about pitching things, branding a day of the week. What do you think of that? Calling Budhwar ko hum wellness day bol sakte hai kya? It's about that learning also. How do you ensure that you make a pitch, position it well, make a nice logo. Like if you have a kind of team there, make a nice logo, pick a kind of theme, use the social media to propagate it, you know, and a visual kind of connects with the people. So kind of a name is important. So try and do that in a way that works well. So that's about branding, brand positioning. So all of us, none of us might be in sales and marketing, but okay, they can go fast on this, Uma. So about how we can brand. So every area, even a college, can be made into zones, and how you can get people to own areas in a zone. So in a typical area here, you have everyone doing everything. You must have heard of the story, how we can do that. So it's about creating ownership, defining accountabilities and responsibilities, ensuring that each area has somebody to look after it. Typically in a cyclone scenario or a pandemic, you know, when there are so many people in the college, how do you keep track of them? So you've got setups, you have leaders, you've got coaches, you've got head boys, all that kind of thing works well. It's about working well to create ownerships. We Indians normally confuse accountabilities and responsibilities. Accountabilities is one, cannot be delegated, and I guess that's something that works pretty well. I guess, for example, we have Mr. K.V. Ranganathan. Happy birthday to you, sir. He's the man, and with the team, with Padmaja and the entire team there, they are the owners. Whatever happens in the college, good, bad, or otherwise, they are the people who own it. So that's about accountability. And all of us are responsible for the reputation of SIA, College of Higher Education. So it's about defining that well. Yeah. It's about being in the Chi zone. A small matrix that tells you what it is. It's about Rasi. You must have heard this. You will learn this somewhere. It's about being responsible, the people who do the task, and accountable is the person who is, you know, who's the owner, who's the final authority, who's the decision maker who approves. So the accountability cannot really be delegated, but responsibility can be kind of done. But the person responsible also has the ownership to complete the task, but the ultimate owner is the person who's accountable. And there's a consulting and inform that goes with this. Important to define role clarity. In companies, people kind of do many things. So also about keeping things simple, how do you ensure that you improve the risk perception? So three questions. So this is about a simple thing about how you can be careful in safety, quality, or in life. The three questions: what am I doing? What are the activities that I'm kind of doing? It's about situational awareness. This is about what can go wrong, what has gone harm, what is the risks, what are the hazards? The third question is, how can I prevent risks? So it's about making simple safety, because in typical industry that you go through, in offices, in plants, in, you know, wherever you go through, in financial setups, in networks, things can be really complicated. But if you want to be safe, be it in a cyclone or be it in the pandemic, it's got to be simple. So you can't give too many stuff. So it's about keeping simple. 1, 2, 3. So what we're learning at Pfizer, three questions and answers. Similarly, driving quality by design, asking questions. And also they say that leadership, you know, a demonstrated actions are important. If the leader of if the chief minister of a state or a prime minister of a country, you know, says something and does something different, you know, people, like they say, monkey see, monkey do. It's also important to know that actions speak louder than words. So wherever you go in the world, whatever your value systems are, stick by that. Let that be your calling card. Ensure that whatever you learned in life, your values, your core values, remain above all. And character is what you are in the dark. So try and ensure that that works well. Yeah. So don't ever take a compromise. And the three questions answers always ask. And of course, similar examples of how we did that. And you can go forward. Yeah, you can go forward. I'm showing the clock there, where the time is going past. It's 12:26. So we can keep going now. This is about how you could, you know, the Tisri Kasam of how you can get things right, how you can brand. Yeah, you can keep going. Okay, I'll pause here, earlier slide, a slide back if possible. It's about the life's lessons learned, the skills. So in a sense, across the years, and this is something that is critical for all skills that you learn. It's all about change. Every situation is a change. Every event, every occasion, be it session one, session two, session three, you've got different links and different platforms and MS Teams to connect. But you always got to make a business case for change. So in every encounter, in every, you know, even when you want a paratha from your mom, or you want some something from anybody you meet in the market, you want a bread, you want to pick up something that, you know, in the current curfew time or whatever it is, or you want a, you know, BMW example, you got to make a case, you got to explain why. And that's important in every discussion. Every message you send, even a WhatsApp message, a mail you send, you got to ensure that you understand what is the end outcome, what are the deliverables. So you got to approach every occasion, you know, as some of you might get into sales and marketing jobs, some of you might not. You got to make a business case for change. Yeah, very critical. If you don't, if you get to the, you know, if you want to tell people what to do, we emphasize and tell them what to do, but the why is more important. So always remember the why, make a case for change, and do it in every place you do. We spoke about this in a couple of examples I gave in the Cricket Club of India. You got to engage stakeholders to develop vision. Who are the stakeholders? All the people who are affected, impacted by what we do. The influencers, it could be the, you know, the community around us, the neighborhood, our family, of course, the teachers, you know, the employers, maybe when you get into the industry. You got to ensure that you connect with all of them. They might not be people who might decide your fate. They might not be your boss, your line manager, but you got to engage most of them at least and develop a vision for the change of whatever you want. And also important to communicate the vision, to kind of explain it. It's, I think, one of the key aspects of what we do here is to communicate the vision, to explain it, and some leaders communicate well, they speak well. You heard Jyoti speaking about a vision, and although you might not want to get a BMW, you still perhaps head around and think around that. So it's also importantly about getting there. So it's about communicating the vision. There'll be people who will object. They'll be like the typical Indian crabs. Somebody climbs up, there's a crab that pulls down. Also important to remove the barriers, understand, acknowledge the people. So they say that before the meeting, create white green ball. So try and take everyone on your side. If you've got a critical pitch to make to the team, their college team, for example, or in office, you get into working atmosphere, you want to make a project pitch, you want to communicate something. So try and engage the people ahead of the meeting. You know, the meeting before the meeting is the most important thing. Why is it important? Because people have seen it. And in the meeting, you can say, like we discussed, as discussed is a typical nice catchword, which says that you're not popping it, you're not bouncing, you're not surprising them with something, some idea. Good ideas get shot really hard when they get into the conference room. So try and remove the barriers by preempting them, by cajoling the people, by at least influencing them ahead of the meeting. They might not agree, but you can always agree to disagree. But at least they will say that we have discussed this before. For anything you do, set milestones, like I said, acknowledge progress, kind of reward and recognition. We spoke about the Kanda Poha, the Bhajia, the Gota, and also about the MS team calendar and Outlook calendar. Set milestones, also celebrate every small occasion. And everything that starts well needs to keep going. You need always to keep reinforcing, right? Virat Kohli by himself, unless he injects energy and increases the yo-yo kind of target, people will not kind of stay fit. Yeah, so we need to also reinforce the change, keep the entire change going, and of course, keep it going again, like a plan to check at. So that's the story of change, the important life skill lesson. And I think with that, I will then talk about some understandings of lessons learned and life skills there. Okay, so the 21st century life skills is all about a very competitive rat race, I know. And you all are the coronials. You are graduating at a time when the corona is going to be under, there's four waves of the typical pandemic. Across the years, you saw the video of Dr. Fauci that could have been taken around 1 year back or even 100 years back. The stuff and the content would be the same, right? So what's the learning across the century? We've seen various pandemics come, and I've been in industries where we planned for attacks there. But the important thing is, how do we plan well? It's the learning that we take in. So what is shared now was the learning, and learning skills are what you learn. Wise students learn from learnings from others, pay the mistakes of others, but you've got to learn from others. So there's critical thinking, creativity, collaboration, communication that is there. But also I'll just speak about these aspects first. There's literary skills for the information, and how do you get the right information? You know, people go to the internet and do a lot of browsing, go to the college library. I'm not sure it's open now, but virtually you might do that. Be authentic on the source of information. One of the key skills is understanding how to disseminate what is right and what is wrong. They say that the WhatsApp forwards are one university that you want to not kind of go to, and nothing against that, but you got to understand and be discerning what it is. The media also kind of will bias you towards opinions. So listen to them, but use your, you know, technical prowess and use technology, leverage it to harness and deliver what you want. Okay. The life skills is also about, you know, how you're flexible. You got to always be ready to adapt. Like I said, in my first, when I kind of got into college, I was offered, you know, I went in for an electronics, I got into a chemical engineer. When I got into first job, I got into a job that was an insecticide company. So could I say yes or no? I did it as it went. I did various roles, wore various hats. You got to be flexible. It could be possible that it might not be the best thing, but we'll always learn. I changed roles in every 2 years in life. Even in a specific company, I've kind of shifted various roles. So it's also important to understand and go with the flow, like I said. To harness your leadership skills the best we can, read the books that you can and get to that, understand, read look at videos that, you know, the TEDx's will get you to understand how that works. Take initiative always, because, you know, there are people who can, or the followers, people who are the leaders, who kind of lead rather than lag. Ensure that you remain social. It's social is not about having 1,000 or 10,000 followers on Instagram or Facebook. It's about being connected, being human. You know, it's a virtual world. While sometimes it is important to understand that we need to be connected, isolation can lead to issues of mental health. This is also important to understand. This is a century, 21st century transition, and the cusp of the transition, we need to be understanding how to do that. Yeah. So it's about beating the competition. And some of the skills that I didn't speak about there, stay motivated, because the things can be bad, but the going gets tough, the tough get going. Also, break down everything into, you know, every problem is an opportunity to learn. So try and break down, do the 5-why analysis to understand, and simply ask why things go wrong. You know, don't remain at the peripheral level of, you know, the event or the human error part of it. Try and go down to understand what the system caused, what the deep rooted cause behind it. Then you'll be able to understand how problems, why problems happen. If you really get to the root cause, like it happened in some of the trees across the Mumbai and some parts of Maharashtra yesterday, you know, it gets, you know, uprooted from the roots. You can't do much about it. You cannot re or transplant it. So same way, if you're able to get to the root cause and try and pluck that, you will avoid a recurrence of that problem. So try and get down the root cause. Don't jump into action, kind of don't, you know, troubleshoot erratically. Don't shoot from the hip, but try and get down to the root cause. I think we'll talk about a lot of these in the future slides, but the last one I'll leave is perseverance. So keep doing what you're doing. Don't give up. So this is a critical skill for the century, and I think this is standard stuff. But across, you learned this in college, I can see that all of you, Ajay, Ishan, Ranjana, you kind of, as Varange, you kind of have coordinated well. Bhuma, you're of course the lady who's masterminded a lot of what you're doing. Thanks for the hard work and the 24th and the late night 23rd, 24th hour hard toil you put in. But beat the college and readiness, you also got to collaborate, do well, try and ensure that you work together as a team. So this is all about collaboration. One of the important things is how you work well. You know, success is something that is, you know, can be accelerated only if you work together. So try and do that together. Try and collaborate. Collaborate is about not you or me winning, but the entire team winning. So that's about it. So the story on Tarkash, while we speak about that, what's Tarkash all about? I think we explained what Tarkash is. I'll talk off while the slides are moving on the story of Ekalavya, yeah, and that Baan that he spoke. You heard of the story of Ekalavya and Dronacharya, the king. You know, Arjuna is very got a lot of focus when he shoots his arrow. He doesn't look at the tree, doesn't look at the leaves, looks at the bird. Doesn't look at the bird, he looks at the eyes of the bird and shoots there. But before that, there was one other challenge there, and you must have heard of the story of Ekalavya. He was a son of a poor hunter who wanted to learn archery to save the deer in the forest that were being hunted by leopards. So he went to Dronacharya, who was the master of the advanced military arts, and he wanted to teach him archery. So he was the teacher of the royal family. So in those days, as a rule, a teacher, a member of the royal family, is not allowed to teach the state art to anyone else. It was forbidden to make anyone as powerful as the princess for the safety of the region. There was a lot of hierarchy even in those days. Yeah. Ekalavya's heart had already accepted Drona as the guru. So what he did, he went home and made a statue of the guru. Maybe that's something you can learn and try and do that. Over the following years, with sincerity and practice, he learned archery and became much better than the princess, the Pandavas and the Kauravas. He became so good at it that he used to hear the sound of the animal, shoot the arrow and claim the animal. Yeah. So one day Arjuna found out about this and confronted him and asked Ekalavya, who taught you archery? And he said, Dronacharya. So Arjuna was very furious. He went down to Drona and said, what is this? You have kind of made somebody more skillful than me when you are the, you know, you are the man who's, I am supposed to be the dedicated exclusive person, people for you. How can you have somebody who is, you know, secondhand citizen who's there, who's better than me? So Dronacharya was baffled and confused at Arjuna's allegations. He wondered who the student was. He himself didn't know. And then he learned the art for himself, but the name and identity he did not know. He thought hard, he could not come up with the answer, but then both of them went to meet the boy. Yeah, you can go on this slide. You can always take 35 and you can go back to that, or 36, you'll get to the slide. So Ekalavya practiced the skills using the murti of the guru. And the ancient times, of course, the practice, and this is what he used, was Guru Dakshina, the token gift of free for the knowledge gained by the student. So what Dronacharya said is, Ekalavya must give you a Guru Dakshina. So he said, give me the right thumb of your yeah, hand. And you know what happens? Without the right thumb, Tarkash and all is irrelevant. So in this story, of course, you see that Dronacharya is being looked at cruel and self-centered, but also was perceived understanding the boy who's learned the skill on his own and is giving it up for the vested interest of the guru. And you know, nobody really remember Eklavya for anything like this. So though the outside it looks like Dronacharya has done injustice to Eklavya, actually Dronacharya elevated Eklavya from being just a student to become the epitome of discipleship. Here is a model disciple of sorts. You know, we'll talk of anyone, a good guru or a guru dakshina or a day that you have this the guru celebration, you look at the person, talk of is Eklavya. So Dronacharya blessed Eklavya with immortality by asking for his thumb. So when you think of devotion, people think of Eklavya, not Arjun. So this is something that has been by the birthday star birthday boy yesterday, is the greatness of Dronacharya was he took the blame on and uplifted the student. So he took the blame of, you know, being the dirty man, uplifting, you know, causing that finger to be given away. So that is why even if the guru is wrong, if a devotion is there, you can never go wrong. But the guru is not wrong. It appears as partial that he uplifted Eklavya and preserved his dharma. So his duty was to maintain the law of the land, and you cannot have much better to do that than the prince. So similar example you might also hear in the Ramayana, where there is Ram who does so many things which makes him very unpopular, including with Sita. So that's some of the learning that you might out there. Yeah, keep going. You've got the slides on a full show. So that's the story of Tarkash. Yeah, so that's, I spoke about that. Go ahead. Collaboration, very important. So critical thinkings, what are the needed four C's? Spoke about each of these. So communication, when you got things to do, you must please also challenge and but also ask questions, communicate openly. Don't go into a shell ever. Work together, like I spoke about collaboration. Critical thinking, like I said, break down problems, look at things from a different way. There are various angles. Typically, if you go to the colleges there, they don't give you answers and solutions. They give you different ways, like unpeeling an onion, the various ways of learning things. So don't look at one answer and don't look at one, you know, question answer is like one question is one answer, not no 1:1. Try to look at problems in a different way, link these learning across subjects and disciplines, and be creative. We spoke about the green hat, wear the green hat, try new approaches, try something different. Yeah, these are the four C's that we spoke about. And if you look at it in that typical way, the creator, the Brahma, Vishnu and Ganesh are the guys who typically are the creator is the guy who produces good work. The collaborator works with others, the communicator understands and communicates ideas, and the critical thinker solves problems. So in a way, this is the pyramid of how the 21st century skills could work well. Try and understand how this works. So the rubric of the 21st century skills works around the four C's again. So what are the elements to break it down? So what is, you know, the background of this also, and could begin or end with critical thinking. It's about information. You know, you got to be able to disseminate, like I spoke about information. You can discover, you got to keep learning. You got to have your ways of interpreting data. You know, the digital world is coming up. There's no way that whatever your stream is, the world, be it HR or sales and marketing or operations or finance or commerce, it's got to be digital. The analytics is what will guide you. So understand analytics is very powerful. Use your skills to understand, interpret. Use reasoning also. We spoke about also having a little bit of emotional quotient. So try and understand things from the head, heart, and the guts. Use the triple filter to, you know, make decisions, construct arguments in a manner that is proactive, in a manner that is not, you don't get to the defensive shell, don't attack, be assertive. And also try and do a system thinking. Think of the bigger picture. We spoke about some elements which kind of gives you a context to what is system learning. It'll help you understand that. Collaboration, of course, taking leadership initiative. Somebody's got to lead, somebody's got to follow in a team. Try and be cooperative, try and collaborate using possibly digital media in this term, and be responsive and give constructive feedback. When people tell you things, kind of be responsive, even if you can or cannot, like somebody we are told to kind of not be anonymous, but try and log out and kind of change your profile. If possible, do it. If not, at least tell that is not possible. So give some constructive feedback. So any feedback is good, provided it is given in a constructive manner. So it's about how you learn. The best way you learn is by taking feedback. So when you do a particular, there's a thing called the Valentine. It's not just the February 14th celebration that Mumbaikars dread, because you say, na, it's also about how you give Valentines to each other, how you communicate, how you give, you know, constructive feedback. Not all goody-goody stuff, but try and ensure that the feedback helps the person improve. Communication is not just about speaking. I spoke about the Pareto, the 80-20. I ended up hogging 80% of the time. It's also giving an opportunity to the other person to listen like they say, when you go in for a pitch, for a meeting, people have roles, don't go alone. Sometimes they say, one guy, you know, when you're speaking, you're not listening. You're making your point, you're building your case, you don't listen. So it's got to be active listening. Sometimes you've got to have roles. Every person in the team, be it the six thinking hats, Edward De Bono approach, or having, you know, a way of learning, you got to wear different hats. Everyone has to be assigned a role, like in a football team, in a cricket team, or basketball, volleyball, whatever guys play in SIA, or used to, try and understand how that works. Presentations make it oral. I know communicating this through a verbal virtual platform, but make a virtual presentation to a teams, deliver it orally, record it, use the verbal cues, use your videos on, don't be anonymous, try and communicate more, how do you share, how do you leverage the nets, engage in conversations and discussions. You learn a lot by running through, by doing role plays. Suppose you want to sell something to a customer, before you go, like I said, the meeting, before the meeting, try and do a low role play between yourself. You could, you know, Swarangi could take a role of the customer, Ishan could be take the role of the, you know, person who's salesman, and one person who's the, you know, the other aggrieved or the interested party. Take the roles in, wear different hats and understand the conversation. So in essence, you're simulating the outcome of a meeting. So you planned it well. So the game plan is what will make you a game changer. Yeah. It's also important to have diversity in the way we approach the business. So have also understand diversity. An Indian in India, the yes and the no kind of can be used differently. You don't shake hands with a person in the Middle East because the pandemic era, nobody would do. But every person is different, from the Europe to the Americas, to Australia, to India, the Middle East. Each person is different. You got to understand how cultures work. You got to leverage their cultures. Maybe this time you'll try and learn this and talk about this in a session tomorrow. Importantly, creativity, ideas. It's all about ideas. You know, have the ideas coming up, popping up. Be open and transparent to creating, exploring, work creatively with others, create productivity and make it innovative. Yeah. In case I'm exceeding time, Uma, I promise that I'll make up. I'll do less tomorrow, but creativity is important. Like, try and be innovative. I think the creator of the 3M Post-it died the other day. So what was it that happened? He created a gum that didn't stick so well. And what did he do? He tried to use it and put it in a yellow Post-it which stuck and which didn't leave a mark, and which could be removed and repasted. So it's about using opportunities in adversity also. Yeah, so that's about some of the things that you could look at. So the 21st century skills, just to recap, are all about critical thinking, is generating questions, evaluating information and arguments, making connections, identifying patterns. So there are some people who, you know, how much time do you spend on thinking of what went wrong in the day, the interactions with people? So about identifying patterns, so some people speak up, some people won't. So in the roles you get into the industry, when you go to the corporate world, the people who will speak up, people who won't, people have different hats. Try and understand their characteristics, try and understand what kind of people they are, and then it will be important for you to play with them. Even if you're managing teams or you're working with colleagues, peers, this is important to understand patterns, construct the knowledge, work well. Growth mindset is important. You work through challenges, show tenacity, perseverance, resilience. You've got to be self-regulated. You've got to be planning yourself well. You've got to kind of be a good citizen, a model citizen. Yeah, it's about, you know, being a good model citizen. There are the good citizens and the bad citizens. You've got to be the model one. As the SIA College product, you've got to be really reflecting the values that have been taught to you over the years. Citizenship is respectfully and positively impacting others and being actively involved in addressing community, national and or global issues. I want a lot of panels of interviews, and when you speak to students, graduating students who go to management schools, B schools, etc., the questions we ask are not technical. It's all about people skills, about leadership, about risk taking, about curiosity, you know, about ethics. So these are some of the stuff that you should really work as a model citizen. Communication spoke about, but you have to understand, you know, settings, global settings, how to communicate, timelines. You know, you might work across people in different geographies. How do you work with them? I spoke with example. I was once in a role where I was sitting in Mumbai and talking, and not talking to, but needing reports and data from people in Turkey, in Middle East, Africa, Southeast Asia. How do you get data? I put in the same dashboard and said, anybody who comes with the report now, these are the parameters. I do a weighted, you know, a color code for people who done well, reported in time, and got them to report on time. So the guy kind of doesn't report in time, there's a red flag, and there is, you know, in a mail also in Outlook, you can put in a red flag as a reminder, and it doesn't happen. You can have a dashboard that's now virtual. You can have it on the, you know, business intelligence is something to talk about, how you can animate all this stuff. So try and do something creative, get cross-functional, cross-cultural teams working, and of course, collaborate. So this, I guess, are good 21st century skills. And how do you break this up? This, of course, is academic, but you know, the foundational literacies are the ones that you need, where you need some of these. and the competencies are the ones that you need to look at it. This is some of what we spoke about. Outside the focus on these competencies and also look at the character qualities. So I said the foundational ones are the ones you learned at the college. You learned all this, be it finance or HR, whatever the kind of subjects you learned. Now look at the qualities you have of curiosity, taking initiative. So these are the values of a system. These are the pillars of any organization: persistence, grit, adaptability, leadership, and social and cultural awareness. A lot of students I interviewed speak about the efforts they made to skill rural India. To, I know all of you are struggling with the power of the last couple of days, bandwidth, how we can understand how it happens in the villages where the networks is poor. I was speaking to a student in Amaravati, and there was a student in Bombay interviewed yesterday, and the wind and the cyclone was causing a lot of difficulty, but also the connectivity was bad. So I know some of you really struggled in the bandwidth, the network over the past few days. This is a lifelong learning, but also how you manage the pandemic and how you manage the cyclone is a lesson that you must learn in life. But kudos to the team for having managed through this workshop in a difficult time. So like I said, the foundational literacies are the one, that's the basic foundation stone, but the competence is the one that we spoke about. The character qualities are very important. They're the social and cultural awareness. It comes from the heart. This one comes from your compassion. Whatever you do, compassion is something that should drive the way you do. Yeah, okay. I think this, in a sense, sums up some of what I spoke about. You also look at the information, media, and technology skills and various learning environment, but this is about a simple thing of how you do that. Yeah. Okay, so now I think is the most important slide, and this is where I pause. I was very impressed by the questions you students asked in the last session. I look forward to questions. I look forward to answering them. I know there is a limited time span, but I think we just managed time. We started half an hour late and we finished half an hour early. So let's take the questions. Any of you want to put it in the chat box? If anonymous, please write in your name so that we understand what it is. We'll try and field the questions as well as I can.
Thank you, sir, for giving your valuable insights on skills of 21st century. You really inspire us. The session is now open for sharing. I call upon Shweta ma'am and Tejaswini ma'am to proceed with Q&A session.
Super.
Thank you, sir. I think the session was really very enlightening, and I'm sure the students would have got a lot of wonderful insights from what you could share with us today. There are a couple of questions. The first question is from a student named A. So Miss or Master A says, I am in standard 12th arts and I am a social person and would like to do work which will bring me in contact with a lot of people. I'm interested in studying history. Can you suggest any vocation that would be suitable to my interests and traits? This is the question, sir.
Okay, interested in studying history. So it's a fantastic museum in Mumbai we can start with. A lot of the museums now are virtual. I'm not sure if you can go in there and look at it, but there are a lot of groups on Facebook and various platforms where you can identify groups that you connect with. It's a virtual world, I know, difficult to say go out and meet people. If you're a social guy, I'm sure find an audience, find a group that you know connects well with what you want to do. Learn from them, make a kind of a virtual attempt to connect with them. You know, feel free to do whatever you think you like, and you know, I have, like I said, been a marathoner in life, and whenever I go out, in every opportunity I had, it all happened. I didn't design it, nothing went as planned. So like I said, I repeat again the fact that whatever you like, try and do it. Live the life that you want, live your dream. Don't hold back if you are in the age where you are and have a lot of ambitions and interests. Explore all of them. Try and, you know, don't be the jack of all, but try and reach to the level of, if not the expertise short of that, try and lead to the level of expertise. If you are interested in history, there's a lot of historical stuff globally also. It's not that you need to be restricted to just Maharashtra or Mumbai or even India. You could look globally in history and learn a lot of that. So in an interview I was yesterday, a guy said, I'm interested in Hindu mythology and religion. And the question they asked is, whose birthday is it today? And of course, the answer like I stick to today was Adi Shankaracharya. It's got to be aware of the answers to the questions. So every time in every very, suppose you get into interviews when you go abroad and all, there'll be questions will be asked on your interests, your majors. There are quiz competitions that we try to scheme you in, but try and be at least, if not expert, be a cutting edge leader in the interest that you have. Okay, hope that helps.
Good afternoon, sir. The second question is from Vishal Goyal. Sir, how to stay motivated all the time?
Okay. That is good. I think you got some role models there. I see some of you, Bhuma included. She's awake all night. She doesn't sleep. Where the energy comes from, I don't know. But it's also about being the spirit of human energy. You got to emanate it. It's something that, you know, sometimes you can see you're born with it or you're not, but it's also can be cultivated. Energy is about being eternally curious. Yeah, it's also the scientific temper that you can talk about. Whether energy comes from within, I think a good, some things work well, a balance of sleep, a good work-life balance, don't overdo whatever you want to do, keep celebrating, take breaks to enjoy, and even when you're with people, let there be gaps in your togetherness. I'm sure that the energy will flow. It's also about good health, okay? Good health is a great life, like you said, be healthy. Even if I was in Australia, like I mentioned in the pandemic, people inspired me to swim, and you know, people are doing marathons even in a room, in a guest house apartment. So a lot of things is, it's all in the mind, as I say, and health is also a good indicator there. It's the bottom of the pyramid. If you're healthy, you can do it all. So it's about mental health and physical health and spiritual health. If you're able to combine all this, you'll always be eternally happy and smiling. A lot of illnesses happen because you are not in the state of mind. You know, the people who manage to come around from as debilitating diseases as cancer, just because of the mind. So keep your mind strong, keep your mind in the times that they say it's difficult to say stay positive, but always have a cheer on your face. Always, you know, so, the feedback somebody once gave me is, you can make out my body language even in my mail. So it's not about putting a smiley, but it's about the proactive, positive communication that you have that makes you what you are. So try and keep that positive spirit. Ishan, if that helps.
So the next question is from Vaishnavi Mani. She says that as an HR student, communication skills are very important, but I am not a very social person. My nature is kind of an introvert. So what should I do to make my communication skills better?
Okay, so I'll give a personal example, Vaishnavi. Don't worry. I also am typically what we call, I've been an introvert all my life. I was in school slightly overweight and I wasn't so confident. I went to a co-ed kind of school and it'll be difficult if I was a guy who would even hide from a picture. I know we go to take a picture now. I'll be the first guy to smile and keep my camera on. I was to hide from the group school snap photographs. That's the kind, that kind of a guy. I went into college and kind of opened up. And, you know, sometimes I'll say a ragging sometimes is bad, but sometimes it's good. It gives you. So there are a couple of workshops that you can do where, you know, you got to drop the inhibitions. You know, sometimes a lot of people worry about the image and the perception people have of them. I'll say that importantly, Vaishnavi, life, don't worry about others. Do your thing. Yeah, I'm saying don't be disrespectful. Don't be irreverent, but do your thing. Don't be so worried about the feedback of others. Whatever you do, there'll be people who will dislike, who will, you know, not kind of approve what you do. It could be even your parents, but in a sense, try and maintain a healthy atmosphere, good balance. That's all I would say. I think you'll break out. I also was in a shell for a long time in life, for the first 14, 15 years of my life, and then I broke open. I still think I'm an ambivert in different situations. I am, you know, when there's a party, I'm the life of the party. But otherwise, in a different situation, I would be quiet. I would wait for people to ask me and then speak. So an ambivert is a balance of the extrovert and the introvert. So in some ways, we are what we are, but we can change and modify it. There's a lot of places you can try this. There is a place like that. There's a Toastmaster kind of platform where you can get in, get connected, Vaishnavi. Try and get into that. It'll help you speak. It'll give you the opportunity to create. A lot of people, you know, need a lot of preparation. You know, if you want to make a presentation or a speech, you spend some 90% of time preparing and the 10% of time in creating how you would speak. So in a sense, you've got to be a natural sometime, but whatever it is, you are that kind of a person. So communication comes in with practice, like anything else. So try and practice your skills, your oral skills, your communication skills. Spoke about some of the elements of that and use this virtual mode to communicate with more people, connect, speak face to face, do a video call if possible, try and avoid, you know, muting your camera down, keep it open. I'm sure, Vaishnavi, you will be blossoming very soon. So A to I to V, are we going in alphabetical order?
Thank you, sir. The next question is from Dhanishtha. How is networking important to our generation? And what is the basic step to start strong networking?
Networking is the heart of not only the 21st generation, but also the 20th generation. That is that our generation has, the millennials, the coronials have. is that you have fantastic platforms, you know, from the TikTok to the various Telegrams, the messengers, to whatever you have, and of course the professional ways of using the LinkedIn and the Facebook. So I guess a lot of people with higher students, higher employees, they also look at the social media platforms. You know, if I posted something that's pretty intrusive or, you know, not so nice, that's something that would go against me. So try and be a balanced, you know, the typical litmus test here is how would your mom or dad react if they saw you doing what you're doing on social media, which kind of came out, or in a sense, if your post or your happening, what you did was exposed in a public platform, in an open platform where the friends and people who love you, what would be the reaction? So try and be balanced in that, but it's all about networking. So like I said, even if the typical, you know, it's not just LinkedIn, it's about connects. If I were to get an assignment or a job or look at the new opportunity, it's word of mouth that gets you the opportunities. Things don't fall in your lap. The typical way of apply will get you no reply. So try and see networking, leverage it. How you can do it, use all the media skills, use it assiduously, use it religiously, build up an image. You know, it's not just about uploading a new DP or changing or adding a, you know, status update. It's about connecting, you know, being in touch, being positive, and also don't, you know, the people who might be sleepers in various platforms, when it's not about saying a good morning every occasion or a, that's not the way, that's not what I mean. But networking is the most important thing, Disha. This is the lifeline of you know, life skills. If you're looking at skills in the 21st century, if there is one skill that you look at, it's networking. Yeah, it's about leveraging the network, using your connects. And it's not as if you're doing anything wrong. When you want to sell yourself, you got to, like I said, prepare a case like we mentioned. So networking is the crucial skill. Yeah, I'd say without that, it is the bedrock of getting your life right.
So the next question is how to cope with self-doubt. The student says, it's an anonymous student. The student says that I have an idea of a startup and I'm trying to get in touch with people, but at times I doubt myself and my idea. How to cope with self-doubt?
So that's a good one. Mr. A, I can call you A. This is a challenge that all of us face. I had a best friend of mine. He was in a company that I worked with. He was the chief risk officer. He left the company and started an initiative of him to look at enterprise risk. So till now, he hasn't got a single client or customer, but when he does, he will really be a king. He has done something that is cutting edge. So, you know, every guy who goes through this phase, and, you know, we take talk of people who want to get into business or become an entrepreneur or set up an own platform. I myself, I'm half Gujarati, so I think I have that in blood with me, but also the other way, I'm from UP and also got, you know, some percentage of me is South Indian. So I'm kind of worried. I am not a risk taker. So there is an element of that in every personality. I'm either a risk taker or I'm a safe guy. So I tend to be safe. So I myself in that loop. But a lot of people in startups, where you do a, you know, like you spoke about the three questions and answers, right? Hey, so you've got to assess, evaluate subjectively what the opportunities are. I don't know if you heard one of the biggest entrepreneurs, a college friend of mine, a guy called Hari Menon. You must have heard of him. He is the man who champions Big Basket. He spoke about a fact that came up pretty strongly in the recent interview, is that do not be too emotional with whatever you're doing. So in essence, if you are keen on doing a startup, go ahead, but look at things from a different perspective. When I left college, you know, some of you will be soon, I went to my professor and said, please write something, something about me. And we gave him the diary in those days, and he kind of took it up and said, I'll get back to you tomorrow. So next day I went to pick it up, and as I passed by, I read it, and then he came back to me and said, sir, what have you written? He was a guy called Professor P.K. Raman, professor of statistics. He had written in that my diary, Shankar, if you want to get moving in life, if you want to get a real context in life, you want to get a perspective in life, if you want to get anywhere in life, .. go to the Himalayas. Yeah. Now this session is all about, my backdrop is about a bridge between the industry and the academics. So what did this mean? Did it mean actually I should go trekking and do the Himalayas, which is something that is on my bucket list? My wife has done it, but I haven't. But the context is, you got to be a kind of fly in the wall. If you are part of, you know, a structure, if you're part of the system, you can't look at things objectively. So in a sense, what the professor and colleague said is you got to look at things from a different perspective. For that, you got to detach. It's about an emotional and perhaps a physical detach also helps. So what also came up in the Big Basket interview was, as a startup, you don't be too emotionally engaged with it to the extent that you're not able to see things from a neutral point of view. Be objective, and sometimes there's some things that work, and something you also set up parameters for success and also parameters for failure. When will you label this initiative, this entrepreneurial effort or the startup as a failure? If you're able to nail that, and then you should dispassionately say, boss, this won't work, and drop it. So don't kind of keep flogging a dead horse. So sometimes if you're able to manage that, I'm sure A, you'll be able to succeed as an entrepreneur and be a fantastic startup. But take the plunge. I would say the opportunities from all the skills we spoke about, it's time to be different. Different things work, as Shiv Khera said. Do things differently, dare to be different, and that's what will get you the rewards. And the risks versus the rewards are great if you do something different. Be innovative, be out of the box. Mr. Anonymous, you will be the biggest name on this planet, I assure you.
Great, sir. I think there are some more questions coming up, but I'm getting a message from the back-end team that the live session may come to an end at any moment. Probably we'll just compile all those questions together and we would send it to you, and I'm sure you'd be able to help us.
We've got a session tomorrow as well. We've got a slightly longer slot. We'll keep some question and answers reserved for that. If you can pop it to me, I'd be happy to.
Sure, sir. Most of the questions are related to networking, collaborations, higher education. Those are the questions that I can see. Some are also related to critical thinking and communication skills. We'll compile those questions and probably send it across to you. And I'm sure our students would be delighted to hear from you.
Works well with the business intelligence and decision making that's supposed to follow. So I think that works pretty well.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, just for taking a snap, can all the teachers switch on their camera and stop?
Yeah, before that, I think we have a sponsor announcement that has to be made. Bhuma ma'am, if you could please share the screen. So we have one of our alumnus who has graciously decided to sponsor for our program. So it's just a small sponsorship. So we would like to just thank and congratulate student.
Super. This is a virtual haircut or a physical one?
With all precautions, maybe it should be physical, sir.
Great. I'll go for it. Wow.
There is also a gift voucher that people can redeem.
Quickly taken a screenshot. Thank you so much.
And this is especially for the Tarkash attendees.
Perfect. Just what the doctor ordered for Sia. This is really, as I say in every Bollywood movie, there's got to be a happy ending. So this is the happy ending. So I love this way the session is ended. Thank you so much for the opportunity to talk to you students, and it's a pleasure to hear from you. Apologies, some of the questions have got culled, but rest assured that we'll answer and take them all afresh tomorrow.
Swarangi, I request you to propose the vote of thanks, please.
Yes, sure, ma'am. Thank you all faculty members for your support, help, sponsors for big support, and most important management team of the Tarkash. I hope all of your doubts must have clear. So let's wrap up this session. Thank you everyone for being part of this wonderful session. I would like to thank Mr. Shankar sir for sparing your valuable time for guiding us. The points which you discussed about your journey, experience, and the stories which you said during the lecture, new normal, six thinking hats, four C's, wellness, and many more. This all going to help us to cope up with the new normal and achieve our career. Remaining doubts and the questions will be you will solve afterwards, I think. Yeah. So thank you so much once again, and use round of applause, use virtual round of applause for all of you guys for being very attentive in the session. Hope you all have gained knowledge from this session. Thank you once again. Stay safe, healthy, and happy days ahead. Thanks a lot.
For all the attendees that have joined us here, we will end this link with this session. There is a new link that is posted on your classroom groups. So please use the new link for the final session of today. And I hope I see you all in the next session as well. I request all the people to switch on their videos so that we can quickly click a picture.
Yeah, ma'am. Bhuma ma'am, can you stop the screen sharing so that it will be clear?
Ah, sorry. You're all looking lovely. Say cheese. Dasli cheese is from Sia. Well done. Have a great afternoon and all the best for the rest of Turkish 2021. Rock and roll.
Done, sir. Done, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Eat wisely. All the best for the next of the session and the rest of the workshop, and a great career to all of you guys.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Madam, event end kar raha hu.
Okay, sir. Fine.
Yeah.
Maitri, tell me. Thank you.